dedication to the independent woman.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Real talk on Stars FM is sponsored by West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland.
It's really, 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 really real talk. It's really, 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 really real talk.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Good night, good night, good night, good night. Good night.
Good night. How are you tonight?
I'm good. Yes. Wanna hear? You good? Tonight, I got a new woman.
Yeah, right.
Yep. Yep, yep, yep. I are lucky. Yes. Listen, is it there on this side or on that side? Good night, people. Welcome to another night of Real Talk. And with me in studio tonight is none other than the sweet, sweet Victoria Miller. She's sitting in for Clear tonight. And we should be having another guest speaker tonight that is also a Styles FM personality. And I know once that person steps in here, it's going to be even crazier than it's going to be crazy right now with Victoria. And yes, Lady Clear, my case get better because the people that miss you already. But we're still going to have a ball on your behalf, right?
Yeah. And I just want to release healing to you right now, Lady Clear. Just by the sound of my voice coming into your house right now,
yep.
Just believe and know so you get better already.
I got the healing. That being the man song? No. Yep. I want to say to all the persons that want to call us later on, our local number is 876-453-1444. That's 876-453-1444. And for the international number, those who want to call us, international number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. 7973. And I have to big up all of the people whether in the Brooklyn and the Bronx, and those in the Brooklyn on the 91.3, and those in the Bronx on the 102.9 FM band. And big up all the people on the Top Choice restaurant, you know, 24/7 them open. So you know if you're hungry by the time Real Talk done, on the 101 head, but no, so the one got full up on the belly in the New York City. Right? So that's those in the New York. And the undergo numbers, Styles FM undergo numbers, are you want to give me the, do that for me, please?
Okay, and that would be for the US and the UK?
Yes.
Okay, for the US, we have 213-992-4360. That's 213-922-4360. And of course, if you want to be on the go in the UK, the number to do so is 033-0010-3322. Again, 033-0010-3322.
Why the UK one? I like it twists up my tongue. 3322. Twists up my tongue. I really like that one. There, you know. And I want people to know you can look us up on social media, social network, on YouTube. Anytime you miss one of the Real Talk show them, you can always go on YouTube and look us up. That's, well, just type in Real Talk, Daddy Road, Lady Clear, and you find all the episodes there. Hook us up on Twitter, Instagram, at Styles FM, and on Twitter is what, at Styles FM 961. So right now we're gonna have a ball tonight, and as usual we have an article to read. You know, you're going to do that on us tonight.
Okay, what I have in front of me here as the topic, it's a monogamous relationship under your mind.
Can you imagine?
Monogamous.
Yes, relationship and your mind.
Can you explain clearly what the topic is saying to some persons? Because I'm sure people hearing the topic might not understand it.
Well, monogamy is basically dating one partner. Lord help. One partner and polygamy is having more than one partner.
You're so happy about that. Okay, of course, we know that God designed us all to be in a monogamous relationship. Of course, we see Solomon way back there. There was a law for it. And so there he was a king anyway.
Yeah.
And his law at the time was that he could have concubines and many wives. But while we are now living under a law where it states that we are to be to one partner.
All right. Like all
Hallelujah.
So, all right, like all me know. Like what, but then you have king, emperor. Like me know when you have daddy. What me can do? Daddy, I must some kind of sitting, you know.
Well, daddy is always the source of a thing.
Our things.
Our persons are. Our things.
Yeah.
But it guess it depends on how one looks at daddy.
Yeah.
Because daddy must make one happy too, you know. And sometimes being in the other relationship, what you call it?
Polygamy.
Polygamy. There's a lot of hatred, a lot of bad mind, a lot of a frustration going on in those relationships, you know. There is always, most of the time, no peace.
No, that's a freedom problem, man. As long as daddy gets sought out.
But it's not. That's it. It's all about daddy.
Yeah.
That was not God's intention.
And then when we reach that age of decline, them start calling me Papa.
Okay. What I have in front of me here to read is, can monogamous relationships survive the temptation? What is it really?
Oh, and for those who don't know, Victoria hosts one of the most energetic programs on Styles FM on a Sunday morning from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. and it's called Lighting My World. And I can tell you people, any dopey in a yo, get up and run. When Victoria a preach, me can tell you, because when she a preach, me can't sleep. All of me kuro kuro run out. All of me kuro kuro. Continue, love.
Wow, that's really lighting. Hallelujah. Okay, we see a Arthur here by Elizabeth. I guess she, that's our last name. Elizabeth Arthur.
Arthur, yeah.
Okay, and what she's saying here, what she's saying is humans are never built for monogamy.
Yeah.
Which I am not in agreement with.
We love Elizabeth.
Elizabeth don't know anything. I tell you straight up. If there were, she says, men wouldn't need billions of sperm cells. That's her take. And woman wouldn't need thousands of eggs. That's her takes.
Yeah.
What's the point of investing so much energy into the sexual system if you are only going to use a few times in your life?
Yeah.
And down here, so she said, understanding monogamy. And what she's saying there, what she's saying there's a little of fear happening all around you all the time. It could be a stolen glance or an all-out affair in the bed you share with your own partner. At the end of it, all evaluation tells you one thing. Men and women weren't built for a monogamous relationship. And this is saying, what is the monogamous relationship? A monogamous relationship is one in which the two partners are completely dedicated to each other.
Yeah.
And have sexual relation only with each other.
Yeah.
Of course, that's how it should be.
Yeah.
Everything. Are all relationships doomed to failure then? Well, yes and no, she says. After all, it's all in the way you think and the way your mind works. Love and relationships are a complex issue that all human beings have to cope with. And so, on one hand, one part of your brain tells us to have indiscriminated sex.
Yeah.
To better the odds for the survival of mankind. Heck no. But at the same time, there is another part of our brain that craves for security and emotional stability.
Yeah.
While one part of you wants to take the risk of having sex with someone else, another part prefers the stress-free, emotional, stable, and happy romance.
I like that part.
You share with one partner.
I like that part.
While stress can trigger an adventurous streak in all of us, most of us still prefer the claim happy life on a regular basis instead of living in a constant state of crisis.
Daddy, daddy.
That's not the daddy, daddy part. I don't think so. Call it your conscience or mess of confused mind. But this constant conflict takes place all the time within your own head. Understanding a monogamous relationship. Monogamy is based on rules of the society, but your mind may not accept it. So set your own rule with your own partner. It's perfectly normal to set your own rule, she says, as long as your partner is comfortable with it. That's a lie. The fact that he lives... That's a lie. Listen to me clearly. All of this is a lie. The fact that we live in the world surrounded by monogamy with huge stakes of... polygamy? Proves that we still prefer the law-abiding monogamous relationship. It's just that we are all having a hard time dealing with temptations all around us. Men and women.
Oh, we're up on a break.
Okay, we're going to take a break right now, and when we come back, you with stupid Elizabeth Arthur.
I love Elizabeth. It's 9:30.
This is Styles FM. Jamaica, Jamaica. The National Youth Service presents their island-wide youth forum dubbed Express Yourself, Exploring Youth Views. If you are between the ages of 17 to 24, this is the forum for you. Come and learn more about career opportunities, youth organizations in your parish, and tips on how to get a job. For more information, contact 754-98168. That's 754-98168. St. Anne, your forum dates are on March 18th, 12 noon at the Abutnot Gallimore High School, March 20th at 1 p.m. at the Monique College, March 25th, 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. at the Brownstone Community College, and March 27th, 12 noon at the St. Anne's Bay Baptist Church.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Maintaining a healthy lifestyle begins at West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland. Open Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. We offer specialized services such as obstetrician gynecology on Thursdays and Fridays, and orthopedics the first Saturday of each month. Get general medical services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., Mondays to Fridays, and 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturdays. For more details, please call 993-283-425 or email westharbormedicalcenter@gmail.com.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Yes, people, and we're back. And do remember that Real Talk is sponsored by West Harbor Medical, and that is located at the KFC Plaza. No, when I get KFC, no, props are just straight West Harbor. Hey, you know, say have a certain place out there, fast food place. When you buy them food, you'll get 2 pieces of this and some fries and one ketchup. One degge ketchup. Now, how can you have that one little piece of ketchup there?
If you eat with everything.
Piece with two pieces of fowl, dry fowl, and fries.
You know, possible.
Then wicked. Straight up, wicked. And when you say, give me one more piece, you have to pay $5 of it.
I do okay, Amik.
Right? That is downright rubbish. That can't go on at all. Give it two.
I give it where you know the meal.
No, man, give it two. And if you get two, we're all right. But now give it one, and then you come tell me about the boy, we pay $5 for the next one. No. So you know what me do? We order my thing, and then me say, can I get one more ketchup, please? Nice little voice. No, daddy rude, little kuro kuro in me. Nice, little decent. Hi, excuse me, may I have another ketchup, please? Oh, you know, you're supposed to pay for it. You know, some never know. Me lie, but me not feel some of a pay feet. Give me two ketchup, and if me want more, then tell me some if I go buy. Different. And when I'm wondering if I something locally, because me get a waga waga.
Yeah, I waga, think it's waga. Local. I think locally. It's local. I think it's just here.
People, join with Daddy Road, we're against that. No more. I'm in a call a name. They must know themselves. Two pieces of fowl, sitting full of fries, and one ketchup. Can't work.
No way. That can't work with you.
That a monogamy. You see it? It can't work.
That is ketchup and chicken and sitting there we are talking about now. But where a man and a woman is concerned. You see, God puts everything in our man. Where a man would a need. And then he look for a man and say, you know, fit for them be alone. And so he put man to sleep and create an arm Eve. That mean everything is in her where that man need. So that man then have to go overboard no day.
You know what Eve rhyme with? Leave.
Might have rhyme with leave, but that no means if you leave. Anyway, this monogamy thing, it's what is for today. And I think that's how God created. Because that sin makes Solomon and them and they indulge in so much. I didn't think that. From creation, at this. Monogamy. Right? So, make we see what going down the line where Elizabeth Arthur talk about.
Where were you? Right here?
While jumping from one bed to another every night,
can't work.
To another can seem like a fantasy come true for many. It's still something that will never make you happy. While we may love the act of the sex while having sex, we still spend the rest of our lives plotting ways to find someone to live with. And that is true.
That's a real talk.
Me, I got talk about that now because guess what? No care you see some man or some woman a jump from one bed to the other. Look here, I just because either somebody when they really love hurt them or something cause them for can't sex.
Something.
And
no,
so,
a real talk, because no matter what, always
somebody needs somebody for love.
Companionship.
Yeah.
True. So you see it. Hug up.
Yeah, man. Somebody needs somebody where they know, say, look here, that somebody are my personal somebody. Then if you have that feeling there, that alone, Jubi. Tell you say.
No, but you can have jubis, you know.
Jubis. You just have do jubis. Jubis can only happen for your time.
Yes. Make sure in a party you're there on this side. This side.
Look here. Polygamy can satiate your sexual desires, but it can't satisfy your needs to lead a well-settled, safe, and happy life. Why you say that? I'm sorry for you. Have you ever felt guilty after kissing someone else or having sex with someone else?
Enough time.
So that alone tell us you're not involved in an outside thing. Anything we are gonna make your heart think, so you know something wrong. We shouldn't do this, you know. You know.
Then if you go up and you not perform well, you're sorry.
It's not about performance.
Yes.
It's about the temptation that you are led away by your own fleshy, selfish desire. Selfish desire. Without even stop to think about what if my partner that I so dearly love find out this is going to ruin us
then,
and so it's selfish.
Then let me ask you something. While you dead, I try to play a good at two shows. partner, run row.
That's not the thing. Because you can't tell, say, so you're going to do this now and say, chop me, I do it here because maybe them are do the same thing.
Yeah.
That's what you're going to do it based on?
Yeah.
No, please.
You don't want to be the one where.
You're going to do it based on how you feel and where your body are.
I never say no feel guilty.
And that's why you do it. Temptation, as they say. Temptation. And so we allow our bodies to just lead us astray all the time. And that's not good. That's not good. We must learn to have self-control. Huh? Hmm? We not allow, we just feed up with body everything you call for, we just get.
Then your body don't know where it want.
Your body thinking where it want. Who rule the body?
If it ever hurt you,
oh,
it want pill.
So if you know, say.
And if your body a call, it want smart. If it answer.
If you know, say, when you eat ice cream, you run your belly.
Yeah.
You go continue eat ice cream?
Walk with tissue.
Yeah. No. You don't allow your body to be a slave master over you. Because that's what it does.
No, but your body will fight against your mind.
Your feelings, you know, is like a child.
Oh.
You ever see one baby? And that baby is there. And as long as you can scream and get anything you want from you, he use it against you all the time. That's how your body screams at you.
Yeah, nothing wrong with
I'm
that.
Teaching you how to submit your feelings and to make your feelings know so you're lord over them. Any day you can do that, that's when you're a real man or a real woman.
All right, no, I'm not ready. I'm not ready yet.
Wow. Mr. Clive, a call. I have to reject that call tonight.
Yes.
I have no option on this. Okay. Reading on. How to have a monogamous relationship working for you. You want to say anything, Daddy Rude?
Mm-hmm. Why would I work,
you
know?
You would comment on this.
No, I will ask someone, a simple thing that, man. All you have to do is just be a nice, goody two shoes, good little guy, good little girl. Love the person that you're with. Know all the things that make that person happy. And you just do what you're supposed to do. Wash, cook, clean. Wash, cook, clean.
Wash, cook, clean, wash, cook, clean, wash, cook, clean.
And then the man now, spend, spend, spend.
No, that's not it.
What?
This person here say, can you care that? A monogamous relationship may feel restrictive, but only if you look at it as a burden. Only if you look at it as a burden. And so here is this person telling you why a monogamous relationship feel restrictive. You see, some man there are some woman and just like free. It's all about freedom to do whatever. They just want to be free.
Want to be roaming.
Yeah, and so anything that they go into that is too committed, that's not for them. They feel burdensome.
Yeah. I have a few brethren that are like that.
Mm.
But one thing I can tell you, all of them, lonely.
Lonely?
Lonely.
They must lonely because they can't have them cake and eat at the same time. There's no way. You understand?
Some of them might eat the cake.
But they're not going to eat your coffee. So this is it. This is it. You know, the other day I was listening, just giving you an example. I was watching some street boy in Kingston. There was this radio personality that goes out there to see what it was like for them washing the car and doing all of that. And while he was there, he was introducing one of the young men to a skill center and asking him if he would like to go there. And, you know, the boy just tell him straight out, no. Cause in like free.
Freedom.
And, yeah, in like free. And even though this was something to help him and take him out of the street, he can't see himself out of the street.
No.
You understand? And in the street, this wasn't doing anything good for him. You know how much man, me see big old man on the road right now look like nobody. Why? And the same freedom they like, you
same
know?
Freedom. That's true.
Same freedom.
That is true.
And that is why, you see, some of them don't want to get in a one good relationship with somebody who did it for them and love them.
Go run with life.
It's not about running your life. You need a woman. A steady woman. You need a man. Young ladies, old woman, if you're out there, you need to know that somebody loves you.
But. Then suppose it's somebody dead.
Well, if
you go find somebody else.
If the somebody dies, then obviously you're going to be there until someone else comes along.
Miss J, my daddy, try your best.
So it's like, all right, where you are, so then you set up yourself. That's if anything happens, you're not leave without.
No, nobody after this. No.
But that's something you hear enough man say it, you know. You can't put your egg in a one basket.
Oh, man. Then I'll me drop out and all. Nah, man.
No. So, yes, suppose your wife should, God forbid, should have passed off.
Yeah.
You think so you can't get one other woman who will love you?
I don't love her the issue.
So, what your problem then?
When I put up my half, again, at risk, you know. I put my heart. Yes, never again. At risk, you know, till death do we part.
Of course, until death do we part, and you better know that, Mister. What did happen to you the last time when you go home?
Left it to God.
All right. And so this is saying there is. It is a monogamous relationship may feel restrictive. But only if you look at it as a burden. If you truly share a great relationship with your partner, you would see that a monogamous relationship can be just as fun or even better than a polygamous relationship. She's confusing. And so, understand what you stand to lose. You can get away with an affair for a while. But would you be willing to give up your own happy relationship just to have a few minutes of sexual pleasure now and then? Is it worth it? I'm asking those of you or everybody out there.
No, it can't worth it.
Is it worth it?
It can't worth it because, as I said, the risk, and if you get caught, I mean...
Well, that's the first thing to consider.
Some of the times, you know, is two things. If you get caught...
If you get caught. Why man always say that?
No, if you get caught.
And then you guys are not so smart.
Women don't get caught.
That's it.
Women don't get caught. A virgin, I'm telling this. Woman no get catch. We get catch. The thing about it is that, sir, you actually have two things to bear with. The guilt and the shame.
Man no bear guilt. It's not about guilt for them. It's just that when man engage in our other relationship, the woman know easy. The first time in start, you can know.
No, sir.
Yeah.
You no can't let me down like
that's
that.
That's what you think.
No make that.
Because you just don't know how if you just... We don't know. Man just don't know if you cover up and conceal in something.
We fool. I not agree with you, but
me
not,
I tell you.
But now I put you under no pressure tonight. No pressure, come. Me know why you left me to God.
When I left it to God, man. If me left it to God, you left in a good hands.
I'm not so sure.
But me understand what I left it to God. All right, understand what you gain. Be truthful about your sexual desire with your partner. Just some int that we are looking into. This one said, understand what you gain. What would you really gain by grouping another body? Now and then, sexual satisfaction for a day. Weigh the benefit of a long-term happy relationship. And you will see that a monogamous relationship can actually define your life and give you a sense of accomplishment. Be truthful about your sexual desire with your partner. The biggest reason why most people stray is because of the kind of relationship they share with their lover. Both partners pretend like they are not sexually attracted to anyone else, and they don't talk about anything but the missionary position. Can blotting your sexual urge ever help the relationship? Learn to be frank, and your relationship will get better. I don't know if this is good instruction. What you said, Daddy Rude? You hear it?
No, of course. If you're frank about your desires with the person, and I just pay mama and papa business, and you say, look, man, right now, more and the thing turn up on a different level. Right? You have to tell them. It's either they can't turn up, and if they can't turn up, they will get burned up.
Really?
Yeah.
So what the missionary? What is this? Missionary position?
Mama and papa.
Oh, mama and papa, you call it too. I still don't know if I understand it. whatever. There might be a reason why this person stayed dormant. There might be a reason why. I mean, even as you say, talk about it. Talk about this. Because, you know, at times you're going on and your sex life can become a drug.
Sure.
And as you said, these things will lead. Come inside. Hallelujah. These things can be a drag. And so we want to make sure that we know exactly what is troubling the female or what is troubling the male that might lead their sex life to be boring. As what Mr.
Not trouble with.
Daddy Rude say. What do you mean not
trouble? Not trouble with.
So you got to tell me some man that did away boring too?
No, I would know that. I don't know that.
Oh, we just have Miss Rose join us. I want to hear her take on that matter. Again.
You afraid?
Okay, what we were just talking about, I'm going to give you the hint again. And of course, this is Miss Elizabeth Arthur. Her name is Miss Elizabeth Arthur. Because I don't want persons to run with it and say, that your minister mill up on the radio on Monday night telling people to do what? This is not my thing. This is something that Daddy would look up and is studying into. And this is, this person is Elizabeth Arthur.
Oh my goodness.
And what she's saying.
You just said Daddy Rude is studying it.
he's looking into it. Be truthful. The topic that I just asked, I said, be truthful about your sexual desire with your partner. And what she's saying, the biggest reason why most people stray is because of the kind of relationship they share with their lover. Both partners pretend like they are not sexually attractive to anyone else, and they don't talk about anything but the missionary position. Can blotting your sexual urge ever help the relationship? Learn to be frank, and your relationship will get better. No, I was saying to Daddy Rude, this is not just the female, even though it's more often with the female, but you have a couple men we're boring too. You back me on that?
People, me not really, I got support while I go on. But now, just I take it easy. Just I take it well easy. Like DJ Mookie, I take it well easy. Welcome, Mrs. Tamara Hilton Rose.
Okay.
We're actually talking about monogamous relationship.
Okay.
If it's boring and daddy, or if polygamy relationship is better. I know which side me depend.
And you know which side I'm on also. Because I'm going to be speaking from the biblical perspective.
Okay, declare
definitely,
it.
Definitely, because it, sister. God did not intend for a man to have more than one woman or for a woman to have more than one man. So definitely, it's not going to be polygamy for me.
One reader.
Satisfy your sexual desire. You know, before we jump to the next place, what Elizabeth is saying, you know, that you should be frank, talk about the relationship, because most time when the relationship get there, because she's saying that this is why most time men and women stray from each other, which is true. I believe that's strongly to be so, but it can't just be the sex, because first of all, when it comes down to sex being boring, remember when you start out, you never boring, you know? You never boring. So what happened during the time that bring it to that point? Most people like to think that it is children, the attention are not there anymore, and so it boiled down that the man and the woman, the wife and the husband, stop dating each other. And so, sex is just the last part that they stop dating. So, long before that, because they fall out of friendship. And so, me just want people to know, if this are going to help you tonight, know this. No fall out of friendship with your husband. Don't fall out of friendship with your wife. Still continue to date every now and again. And when I said date, you have to make the time.
You have to, definitely.
You have
dates
to make
are to be planned in relationships.
Right.
You can't just...
When we find the time.
Exactly,
you're
so.
You're never going to find the time.
Yeah, because in some relationships, you have like date nights. Mm. So if you're really busy. For me, it used to be a Saturday night. Mm. Right? So I would... Because my weeks are very busy. Weekdays,
right.
Really busy. So Saturday night, that's when we go out. That's when we have fun. So you have to plan your dates.
That sounds boring.
Nothing about it
boring.
About that's what I'm saying.
You must have spontaneous, like, you just know
since
Saturday
night. Of
course
you can be spontaneous.
Saturday night, you're goat. Sunday night, you're goat.
I'm not saying that, I mean, we went out only on Saturday night or we go out. But, yes, definitely Saturday night was family night. The night when we would be definitely together. Nothing at all would stop us from being together.
You know, I'm a hypocrite. Because I remember when we just meet my wife, he sat there, did fear, I book out, not other woman. I was straight, she.
But what may I tell you is some people stop dating.
Yeah.
They stop dating and that's it.
We stop date.
Then it may assure you say if you stop date, what gonna happen?
We done tend that win already, you know.
No, but you need
yes,
to.
Well, may I assure you?
You need to.
Because you know how much money spent up.
But that's not good. We need to see our lover the same way like how when we did see them first and
you need to maintain the
that,
friendship
yeah,
and the relationship.
The friendship must be maintained.
In order for the relationship to grow, it must be nurtured. And that is why some relationships get boring, as you were saying earlier. Because those things that you used to do, you don't do them anymore. And so it becomes
and it
boring.
Was those things that lead to marriage.
Exactly
and all of that.
Exactly so. So you have to keep the fire alive. And all the things that you can do to keep the fire alive is dating.
Right.
Another lead to marriage in my situation.
So you never date?
Me? Oh, I spend some money, so man. I take them, yeah, I get them back right now.
Yeah, but you can still, you don't have, you can still date without having to spend a lot of money.
Well, you can
there's
no,
so many things.
The money
exactly. You can do things within your home and still, you're still dating your wife.
Mm.
Right? You can have a candlelight dinner.
Candlelight
breakfast.
Let me go talk about the candle business.
And
what I want to say to the female, please still keep your body looking fresh.
Yeah.
Young. Take care of yourself.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We need
praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
This is
like,
it.
Like, seriously.
We need to keep taking care of ourselves so that we can make ourselves attractive to our husbands. Okay?
Simple. That may I talk about.
But you can't look the same way you look like when you're 16 or 20.
Well, I'm in agreement.
Still Marga.
You might can't look the same way.
Still Marga.
But you still can't take care of yourself.
After having 5 and 4 children.
That necessarily have to pop down.
Yeah.
After having 4 and 5 children?
Yes, you take care of yourself. Okay. Take care of yourself. Yeah. Take care of yourself. Don't wear the rugged clothes. You know your husband is coming home. You get out of them clothes. Even before me start cook sometime, I be a dress up and put on. Because you know I look rugged.
Yeah.
When he come home and look here.
If you have a wife who's a career woman, there are some exceptions to this rule. Because I'm talking about me right now.
But what I'm talking about,
all my days are busy.
When you're in the house.
So don't you're not gonna have time to dress up every time.
What?
Right? So
well,
you don't even have time to cook the dinner.
Well, you might not have time to cook
with the dress up night.
I have a dress up night.
But it can't be every night for me. And
well,
and
I'm not gonna say it's every night. Cause just like how you're tired, the man tired too. Cause some man go and like say them can't tired. So me want to know what do them? How I run for them in gin. You think I joke? And so it is. This one here says satisfy your sexual desire before the urge heightens. And it says you fantasize about other people now and then, or you recreate sexual thoughts with someone else in your head when you're alone. Over time, these urges will force you to make mistakes and move away from monogamy. And you see, that is the same thing I say about dating. Because every now and again, as Kanta, she, you fantasize.
Never fantasize, man.
No, you see, if you have your woman and you go out with your woman and things are going on, all right, all of them, they are just fantasy. They stay in your mind, no times. You're not even remember them.
No, but you fantasize and then your woman execute the fantasy.
Right. You and that person sharing that monogamous relationship.
Yes, ish.
Yes, ish. So what is the part that is missing?
Flexibly, you know. We're up on a break. When we get back, come to the second hour of the show. Real talk.
This is Styles FM. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle begins at West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland. Open Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. We offer specialized services such as obstetrician gynecology on Thursdays and Fridays, and orthopedics the first Saturday of each month. Get general medical services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., Mondays to Fridays, and 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturdays. For more details, please call 993-283-425 or email westharbormedicalcenter@gmail.com.
Ladies, ladies, ladies. Something is on for you on a Tuesday night.
Music.
No more loneliness. Now you have Prestige, your ultimate companion. Experience his musical charm with charismatical passion. So innovative and more interactive.
From 10 p.m. to 1 a.m.
on Styles FM. Music with Prestige. Don't miss it.
With Styles FM on the go, you can listen to your favorite programs by calling the USA number 213-992-4360. If you're in the UK, it's 033-0010-3322.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Real Talk on Styles FM is sponsored by West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland.
It's really, 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 really real talk. It's really, 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 really real talk.
Yep, we're back, we're back, we're back. And so we're now at how to add?
Affairs are more
fun. In the head.
All right. So we say that affairs seem like a lot of fun when you think about it. It is so sexually liberating and enjoyable. Yes, isn't it? But have you ever thought of the different emotions and games involved in the whole affair? Sex could last an hour a day, but you still need to deal with the affair for the rest of the 24 hours. Is it worth it? When you really weigh the odds against each other, you would see the real benefits of monogamy and polygamy. So, in essence, what this is saying is that, you know, affairs are more fun in the head than actually getting involved in extramarital affairs. So it is best to think about the negative impact of affairs instead of just going ahead and enjoying what something that would last for an hour. Think about what will happen after, the impact after, you know, being involved. Why that, sir?
So go on, Bill.
No, I've nothing visited tonight.
No, I'm just go on, Bill. But may I listen to you, you know?
How to add to a polygamous streak? How to add a polygamous streak to
monogamy?
Monogamy. Happiness is a state of mind. If you still find your mind conflicting over
monogamy.
And polygamy, it's time to learn to trick your mind into believing that you've got a polygamous streak in your life, even if it's all monogamous. Your mind triggers sexual interest and creates polygamous scenarios in your head, and it wants to experience all those fantasies in the real world. Use these three tips to satisfy these sexual cravings with your partner, and you'll have an exciting sex life, even in a monogamous relationship. Don't restrict, and the first one, do not restrict your life when you're in a relationship. Respect your partner and ensure that you feel secure in the relationship, but don't avoid flirting or talking to people of the opposite sex. If you intentionally stop yourself from getting sexually attracted to someone else, you're bottling up the sexual emotions in your head, which may eventually lead to a sudden burst of sexual affairs. I think we need to discuss this. We need to. Do not restrict your life when you're in a relationship. I mean, the fact that you're in a relationship, you're restricted. So how are you gonna prevent that from happening, Victoria?
Okay.
So based on the article, it's actually suggesting that you should flirt and talk to people of the opposite sex while you're in a relationship.
On a bun note every week, you see it?
That's what the article is suggesting.
So you have to flirt.
So do not restrict your life when you're in a relationship. So even though you're going to be respecting your partner, and you're going to ensure that you feel secure in the relationship, you must not avoid flirting. I'm not understanding what's happening here.
That's why I'm saying confusing.
What's happening
so
here?
She's so confusing.
Because if you're going to be doing these things, then you're going to be encouraging certain things to take place.
Yeah.
If you're going to be flirting, then you're going to be setting up yourself exactly for getting involved further in a relationship, because the more you flirt with this person, the closer you're going to get with this person,
because you're
then you're going to eventually get closer till you don't know what may happen. Right? So I'm not sure if I'm agreeing with what's
saying
right here.
Basically, when I always tell you, people, it's simple. Like call me now as a little married man at the business. Me can't just dead it as a young youth and go on like me now. Me get rusty night. I have to make a little talk here and there to see if me still have it.
Yeah, but the when and you have made a decision, Mr. Jackson, to get married,
Daddy
to tie the knot.
Daddy Road, you can't make people know that. Daddy Road.
Daddy Road.
You're going to be Daddy Road when Cleo is here, and I hope she's listening.
Daddy Road. Know?
But listen, once you have tied the knot, you have basically said to the world and to everybody, my days of flirting is over. My days are over.
My days of talking to people of the opposite sex are over.
You should not be talking with anybody of the opposite sex once you are married.
My girl, ask Miss J.
That's the point. So any flirting that's going to be going on will
happen between you and her.
You cannot flirt with anybody outside your marriage or your relationship.
So me still a
driver. Alright, why you say you flirt?
If it's going, let me still have it.
You want to say you have some game left?
Knock it, Dex. Knock it, Dex. That me a talk about.
So,
simple as that.
Flirting with your wife, you know, believe so you have game left.
No, sir. It's Jackson. Spend up and money burn up and maybe big panda and win. You understand? So right now, you have to just go and see if me still have it. Suppose she left me.
You start over again.
You don't have no confidence.
So you go me back not, in. You start over the game. You start learning the game again.
I don't think you are confident in yourself. Of course. Because if you have to flirt, because you're not sure if you have the game.
No, I never say I'm not sure if I have a game. I say more make sure I still have it.
Then that.
Make sure. We can't rust it. You think then train?
What? There's a point waiting, that she has
made. There's no way that you can be living with somebody and rusty.
Hey, care. And now I don't like some of the athletes that take little jogs. I train feet.
You know, sir. You have a guarantee, sir. Most of who out there in this polygamous relationship.
Yeah.
You're going to have a better energy level and all of that over them. Because enough of them burn out, you know, and if you use drugs. They don't have no back left.
Wow.
Blue pill.
You understand?
Have mercy, Jesus.
Yes. Yes.
Especially the one they will love drink rum.
Yes.
I can't give them some roots, you know, they can check me for some roots. I'm not paying for that ad, Mr. Sir. They can check me for some real Clarendon roots, man. I'll give it to them.
For real.
I have a punch I used to make for my husband, married man punch.
Whoa.
And you know, when. You know what resulted from giving him that?
Yeah, but it's only like right now, we're done. You would be surprised. Because then start from early.
Where call early?
Early. Too we are early. Back up in them 15, 16.
Yeah, too early.
Too early.
So I didn't get to enjoy.
And some of them start use, what you call it, studs and then something there.
Hold on. Somebody sent me a text. 15 and 16 early for boy Pitney.
Of course.
More than 15 and 16 early.
I do not want my son to start having sex at 16. Definitely.
17 then?
No, when he's married.
Read on. Read on.
I'm serious. Sound
to me like we are boring to death.
All right. that is what happens when he brings Christians on his program, yeah? This one is kinky right now. She's suggesting, there's something that she actually suggested in the point about not restricting. She says that if you intentionally stop yourself from getting sexually attracted to someone else, you're bottling up your emotions, right? Therefore, you'll eventually explode.
Lie.
Right?
So, lie.
So, you know.
No, go so. That's just fantasy. You go out there today and you look past my day and see them. You don't have that in your mind straight, I carry you, unless you're sick, you're a pervert.
Mm-mm.
Why?
Why in a God's name you don't see one woman out there and when you come home, you can't stop thinking about him? Something wrong with you.
No, man.
You don't ask him, I tell you, but if you're a regular man and a sensible man, but you drive down the road and turn the curve, you don't remember her. That. I don't ask no question. It's only a pervert
true.
Carry that them people that will rape.
That means I'm unique and irregular.
You know, no, man.
All right. The next one, indulge in kinky ideas. Kinky. Yeah. Try to relive the fantasies and sexual desires in real life with your own partner.
Now that me telling a man.
If you want to have sex with a doctor, ask your partner to dress like one. Be open and truthful with your own partner and explore your sexual desires. So if you want your partner to look like a policeman, have him dress up like a policeman. Or if you want to... If you
all
want
of that are foolishness.
To,
what?
All of that are foolishness.
So you're basically... Foolishness.
Because
living in a fantasy
yeah,
world.
Yeah, that's fantasy. And that is why you see these kinky people. Then going at the threesome and the twosome and what you want to call it. Because when you go put on different what you call it?
Costume, yeah.
Are the people them you want? You want the different, yeah. So you know, dress up. But you can do it. Because if you did one policeman, you're married to one. or whichever.
So you care one doctor, police, everybody. Must be one.
What's wrong with you, man?
No,
all right.
Yeah, perform a surgery.
There was this movie that I used to watch as a child growing up, and the patient said, "Are you a doctor?" And the guy said, "I am today." you know that movie? You know? So I guess you just need to be, well, she's suggesting
pretend
that you be, whoever you want to be in your relationship. And I guess this is like in your bedroom.
What you fantasize about?
You know, so honestly.
Because would I like for you, you're real.
No, I've lived them all.
Oh, yeah. you have lived them?
I've lived them all, yes.
Okay.
Wow.
My cool and all, my trackle.
Thank the Lord.
You're going Jesus. Like you're that fool.
No, my trackle.
Well, it's good to know that you're cooling and chuckling, as you
that,
say.
Yeah, the engine shut off, you know, it
of
track.
Of course, your engine could have never shut off, and I don't think that it is chuckling.
Just a bit of know.
If it a chuckle, you're sick.
All right.
Why is the engine a chuckle now?
I guess he's parked or something like that.
Yeah, man. No, my so, park. That's like what.
The engine is still igniting, but he's parked. He's not moving. He's going nowhere.
When would you consider to be driving?
Be driving? Well, when it's time to move on.
So were you driving before you got married?
Oh, yes, man. 100 miles per hour down the road.
That's right.
Oh.
Yeah.
So you almost kill yourself.
You understand.
Nah, man, I've on my seatbelt.
Yeah, right.
Speeding kills, you know.
But I'm a survivor.
You're a survivor.
All right, then the next point says, involve your partner to do more. Are you having a hard time staying faithful no matter what? Well, your last resort may be to involve your partner and test the waters of infidelity together. In a manner, you're not being unfaithful because you're involving your partner to participate with you. And this is crazy. I won't even read any further.
You have a demon.
This is crazy. Yeah.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Is she even suggesting that you should involve your partner in being unfaithful?
When we look a bit
we're not even going to be reading any further because we may not be able to come on the radio Sunday morning, Sister Victoria. Because guess what? People are going to be saying, what happened to Sister Victoria and Sister Tamara?
Look here. You know, it don't really matter to me because this is the dinner. Persons are indulging in this. But I want to be the one with open people's eye tonight.
Exactly.
And make them know. Say, look here, see them somewhere.
It is wrong.
It not only it is wrong, if you find yourself feel so you need to get a checkup.
Thank you.
Straight up.
Yes. That's a little joke.
Thank
yes.
you.
No, man, let me in here, my boss, and my call. The Christian never feel act yes. like a devil in me.
No, This is not right. Yeah, no, I thought when she said involve your partner to do more was getting your partner more involved in your whole sexual relationship, doing things together, you know, planning, you know, doing whatever to make your life more interesting. How could she even be suggesting that you get somebody? You test the waters of infidelity together. She is crazy. She has lost her mind because this is definitely a no. No, maybe there are listeners out there who think that it's okay, but for me, it is not. I totally disagree.
I'm not
with
going
it.
To say it is not. Me no say not nothing, sir. But there are other things that person must know and must understand. That look here, then something are really not. People feel them way, you know. People feel these way, you know.
Yes.
And they are sharing in these kind of relationship, you know, and they are living it. Not understanding what is the driving force behind all of this.
True.
Now let me let you in on something that persons cannot accept. But most of the time, persons like this are oftentimes demonic.
Mm-mm.
It is coming straight from the pit of hell.
It cannot be coming
it's
anywhere.
It's not normal.
It is not. Involve
it
your partner
not
to
normal.
Do more.
And so sometimes when you feel certain thing, look here, man. If you ever take yourself, and if it worse, if you feel like it overpowering you, that is something beyond you, pushing you into this kind of lifestyle.
So you're saying that persons who involve in what they call, oh wait, name again,
this some?
No, man. I'm going to find a nice word for it. Swing.
Swingers. What is that?
Swingers, they have a group of people. I'm just exchanging partners.
That is crazy.
Then you don't like physics.
Those people are mad
you
people.
You go somewhere now with your wife. And you sit and watch your
exactly.
exchange partner. Come on, tell me about exactly. the polygamy.
I'm talking about them, not me.
that's crazy.
No, man, that's really crazy. Can we get some call on this tonight? What do
I
you think?
I don't even want my husband to talk to another woman, much less.
To go watch him.
Much
in
less. It must be crazy. I mean, that's when I'm going to get violent, man.
Jealousy is a sin.
It must be mad.
Jealousy in
absolutely
which way?
Absolutely not.
Jealousy is a sin.
Jealousy in which way? God jealous. Jealousy in which way?
That's wrong.
It's my husband.
When the people that do help, never burn me out neatly. Never burn me out neatly. Come on. So let me ask another question. So what we've read so far in this particular article about monogamy is what you would say is God's way.
It's
and polygamy is the devil's way.
Polygamy, I don't know about polygamy, other area where they legalize these things, you know, because remember say everywhere legalize in a certain country.
If it can,
it was never God's intention, you know, for a man have many
wives. Right. It was never his intention. If that was his intention,
hold on.
He would have created
many wives
Adam and many other women. He did not do that. He created Adam and Eve. It was as a result of sin.
Yeah, I mean, just tell him
right mm-hmm. why all of
sin?
That happened.
What was
right? So when you look at like Abraham had one wife, but because of sin. And sometimes we don't wait upon the Lord as we should. Exactly. He went and he got Hagar pregnant. And as a result of that, that's why we have them people down in the east fighting against the Israelites and that sort of thing. Right? And then Solomon, if you read Solomon's story, at the end of it all, after having 300 wives and 700 concubines, he said that all is vanity.
It makes sense.
It makes absolutely no sense. All is vanity.
No, but him live it enough to tell it enough, so.
But at least he live it.
So
who you want to hear it from?
Well, I'll find out for myself.
Really?
My brother, you're crazy.
So because I see people having all sorts of diseases and stuff, and especially one of the main ones now, which is lifestyle disease. HIV, AIDS, and it's as a result, I believe, of polygamy.
Look here.
Right?
Okay, hold on.
For me, I believe.
I was at,
and that's how it is spread now.
I was at a meeting,
you know?
The other day, and the representative from the Ministry of Health told us that nowadays, a person that has been living with HIV lives even a more healthy life and is more likely to live longer than someone with diabetes.
Yeah, we are conscious
are
of
you
that.
Endorsing AIDS?
We yeah. are conscious of that.
I'm just letting
we are
because
aware some, of
because
that.
Persons make it appear as if the HIV is the result of
disease.
Sin. Is a result of sin.
No, I'm not even suggesting
it's
that.
It's not the killer disease.
But it's one of
but
the
it's
diseases
a disease that contracts
as a result of polygamy. Having multiple
not
partners.
Necessarily.
Not for the main part. For the most part, it is. For the most part.
For the most part, that's what it is.
No, it is mainly transmitted
so let me ask
through
a question.
Sexual contact.
Yeah, but are you suggesting that from birth?
So even a baby who has HIV AIDS is as a result of sexual contact while that baby is born with AIDS.
Right.
Yeah, but not necessarily either. Blood transfusion.
Mm-mm. No.
It could happen.
Yeah.
It could happen. And I don't think that is very prevalent right now based on the basic you know, the hygienic steps that have been taken to ensure that, you know, the blood is in the best condition and everything is all right with the blood, you know. But the main
thing,
way in which it spread, is through sexual contact, and sexual contacts through polygamous relationships.
Yes. All right, now I'm a sad friend.
Me know you can't manage this tonight. Anyway, me you talk tomorrow. Because you know, I thank God for salvation.
Have to.
And when I said I really must thank God for salvation, when I look at my life before, and I see where I've exposed myself to a lot of things that could have happened. You see some people got dance, and they don't know the man or the woman from Adam. And then just a rub up on each other and a blow on each other's face. They don't know each other, you know? They don't know if this man mouth still, you understand? Mm-mm. And I've seen it so often. You don't know man or woman from Adam, but yet still that dance.
But nothing wrong with that.
And a rub on each other.
Nothing wrong with that. No, nothing wrong with that. Because
there's a whole lot I see wrong with it now.
No, man, but a lot
Before, I didn't see anything wrong.
No, but a lot of people meet their partner, their husband and wife in the clubs. At parties, at dance.
Yes.
Nothing wrong with that. The same rub up, just see her.
You could have met her other places as well.
No, we could have, but we never
meet. You know, much smart to meet other things that are rub up on each other.
Yeah, couple of youth.
Look here, man, you know, sensible.
But which one of them go to the church?
Me not saying at the church. You can't go in at the park.
The park.
You can't go for an outing. You can't go so many places.
It depends again on the kind of man that you're looking for, the kind of woman you're looking for.
No, sir. Not stigmatize the club at all.
No, I'm not. I'm not. But I know people.
Yeah.
Right? And they've been trying to like find a man for years.
Yeah.
But they're just going to one place to find a man. Mm-hmm. And most of the men that they find, they have the same characteristics because they're going to the
same place
to find the man.
They're not for them kind of man that.
But
that's not the kind of man they want.
These relationships don't work because the men, they don't want to do anything but party and drink. They don't want to work. They don't want to do anything at all. So they party for the whole night, sleep for the whole day, and
party
again in the night. Right? I mean, how sustainable can a relationship of that nature be?
A frenzy.
How long can you be in a frenzy?
How long as you want it to.
No.
And then you move on.
When reality hits, it's something different.
That's when you get sober.
Exactly. And then you realize that you're hungry. And you want food. And the bills are to be paid.
And then you get drunk again. You drink it all away.
So you're living in a continual frenzy.
I'm glad you explained, you know.
Yeah.
I'm glad you explained.
That's crazy.
Because that's the street.
I would never want to date somebody, not even to talk to for a minute.
That's the street.
Somebody of that nature.
That is the street that our young men, our young women, and even our elderly, because me see some people out upon the road they know and then just are going like say, they're still young. You understand? And when I look into it, I pity them. Because when I look at how they are yearning after these things.
Yeah, but remember, you know.
Remember what?
Reveling has existed for years. It's a part of lifestyle, it's a part of culture, it's a part of how some people release stress. So nothing is wrong with reveling.
Look here, reveling has been introduced and in for years from the day Adam and Eve fall into the garden. And I want to tell young men and women and boys and girls, fall into sin.
Oh.
Right?
What was the sin?
What was the sin? Disobedient.
What was the disobedience? What did they disobey?
They disobeyed God.
Yeah, but what was the...
They were told not to eat a particular fruit in the garden and they went and eat it.
Dr. Black.
It was a test of obedience. It had nothing to do with sex.
It has nothing to do with sex.
Because I can't see you thinking.
So many people is saying this is sex.
Do with
oh
sex.
My goodness.
And, right?
I swear.
Most of
it's just
talk
like
about
I put my phone right here and I said to my baby, do not take up the phone. Let the phone stay.
I swear I wasn't thinking
right?
about sex.
If no, but I'm telling
once
you,
in my life,
that is rude.
That time.
You know, and God gave them an instruction and they went against the instruction. Right? So it was a test of obedience.
But you see, most time when God tells us to not do something, it's always something that you should not do because it won't benefit you.
Yeah, but if we eat one apple, the whole
but it was not just a one apple. It was not just a one apple.
And cherry.
It wasn't.
It wasn't a cherry.
Was it?
The word of God
apple?
Calls it the forbidden tree. The tree that he calls the knowledge of good and evil. Right? And so this wasn't just a one apple. We see what the one apple, as you call it, did to the human race. And as a result, them have to start revel, as what you call it.
Yeah.
And them have, if they not do these things, then can't hold a vibes, as you call it. Man never built to live like that.
So, and that's why...
That's sad.
That's why Key and Duke Abel and Abel.
You're speaking fables right now.
Cain, Juk, and Abel.
You're speaking fables.
All because of sin. They were falling into sin. When man fall in a sin, you know. When Adam sin, you have to understand where you're going on.
No, but it wasn't it as a result of jealousy?
Jealousy?
Yeah.
Where did jealousy come in?
Yes, it was.
Yes, but, so but all of that was coming from the nature of sin.
No, but which would mean that Cain was living a godly life, a godly feeling. He was being jealous.
Cain wasn't living a godly life. Cain was now left to his sinful nature. He never have no...
He made a choice.
He never have no... Look here, even though I make a choice, you know, man was bent on the sin. It's like man being into something that they can't help themselves. When Adam sin, Adam have all of the human race in him already.
He was tricked into temptation by the woman. We're up on a break and we'll come back. We're going to have...
We need to talk about this.
We're up on a break, people. Because I'm telling the truth. In your warm and AC turn up.
No, man.
Stars FM, you're my number one. For the best quality in sound reinforcement and backlining, Native Audio. We have professional engineers with over 20 years of experience. So call us and we'll take care of your parties, wedding receptions, barbecues, conferences, and small stage shows. Crystal clear sound, Native Audio. Our prices are the best. Call us at 871-5212. That's 871-5212. Native Audio. We make your events audible. 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 Audible.
Babes, where are you over there, sir? Babes, where you really are you over there, sir, babes?
Me a look for the radio cause I some schizophrenia with DJ Mookie. Him have mad skills and crazy hype. And he's on this and every Tuesday and Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. No, me can't miss it. You're mad.
Oh, what?
Maintaining a healthy lifestyle begins at West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland. Open Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. We offer specialized services such as obstetrician gynecology on Thursdays and Fridays and orthopedics the first Saturday of each month. Get general medical services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., Mondays to Fridays, and 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturdays. For more details, please call 993-283-425 or email westharbormedicalcenter@gmail.com.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Real talk on Stars FM is sponsored by West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland.
It's really, 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 really real talk. It's really, 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 really real talk.
We're Real talk. Real talk.
Social work hard for your money.
Very hard.
Very hard. Extremely for your money. Hard. And it's a nice song, Cass. It just fit the topic in terms of our main discussion tonight. You know, we normally read the article and, you know, exactly the first time reading an article and getting that dimension of analogy into an article. These ladies went really and truly deep in the article. I better the truth. I'll feel guilty. I myself with somebody sitting there. Because while I'm reading them, I said to myself, yeah. January, so the thing we set. But right now, me not eat no apple. No apple me not eat.
Amen.
No apple me
not
eat.
Hallelujah. That song converted tonight.
Exactly. We're going to have to say a prayer for him before we leave.
Yes.
And we have a few texts. You wanna read the text, ladies?
Go ahead, Jamar.
Hold on. Let me see what's happening here. All right. So somebody's texting to say, not practicing monogamy does not equal to cheating. You want to say anything on that?
That's because he's not in a relationship.
Who knows that he? No, you saw me talk, Cassidy. You saw me talk about
she.
You saw me talk about
what can I say? He's not. He's not.
No, sir. It's them bias over there. No.
I hope this listener is not offended, but right, exactly. Mm-hmm. All right, the other person says, God at no point in the Bible said only one wife.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Are you sure about that?
There are many.
In fact, there are many cases that differs. Yes, we know there are many cases that differs, but what we need to use is what happened in the Garden of Eden, mm-hmm. when everything was perfect on earth,
right.
before sin entered.
Yes, as it was in the beginning.
Adam, it was
so
Adam and Eve.
That's what God is after.
We didn't have Adam and Eve's. It was just Adam and Eve. All right, so the caller continues to say, God at no point in the Bible said only one wife. In fact, there are many cases that differs. And if you were listening, you would have, you know, heard us mention about Solomon and his many wives and the vanity of vanity that he said at the end of it all.
Yes,
all is vanity. And then the person went on to say, next, I do believe we were not created for monogamy. Oh, really? However, we can make a choice to commit to one person. I believe honesty is a bigger issue than monogamy. I do believe we should set our own relationship rule. I think you should read the article then state your opinion. Thank you so very much, my listener. Your point is valued, and we do not agree with you on everything, because as I said earlier, you know, what we believe and what we say in our discussion is based on the Bible, because we believe in the Bible. Thank you.
And just to add to that point, where that person said we were not created for mahogany, or we call it monogamy. Neither were we created for any other kind of relationship. We were built for worship.
Let me ask a question.
We were built for worship.
Let me ask a question. I have a serious question to ask. During mating season, dog them a sin?
We are not animals.
We are not animals.
No, man. Sin a sin, man.
We are not animals.
Them not a sin.
We are not animals. You could never put us in the same category.
Well, on primates.
I am
all
not
right.
even
primates.
Going
primates.
Into
primates.
That kind of discussion,
primates.
Mr. Jackson. Because
God primates. Said in create you, as in
no,
create
primates.
Humans. As in self.
Thank
primates.
You.
So when you look on yourself, you should see all the characteristics
no, man.
Of
well,
God.
No, man. Sin a sin, man. When one dog bite upon man, is it a sin?
Dog were made to bite.
A man was made to?
To live like God in the earth. The word of God said, God put Adam and Eve in the garden and he said, have dominion, rule the territory,
exactly.
reign over the territory, keep the territory. Man was created to live like God in earth, like how God rule heaven.
Let me ask a question, another question. Was Adam given other gifts before Eve?
Gifts in terms of?
To keep him company.
No.
Sure.
No.
Alright.
You mean in terms of the plants and the animals and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, those were made.
Those were made for him. Those were made for
him. But he wasn't happy.
We wouldn't say he wasn't happy, it's just that he did not have a companion.
Oh no, them said dog a man best friend.
Who says that? Did the Bible say that?
Why you laugh, Tamara?
That's a fact that you're learning.
A dog is your best friend.
Me,
thank you so very much. Exactly.
Me no like dog.
Exactly.
Where they even talk about friend? Dog can't chat back to them.
Exactly. So
man a dog slave. Dog can't bed himself. Dog can't cook for himself. Mm-hmm. You have to walk dog. Me no like dog. And then me no and a dog and I come to my yard. Come to what to my yard?
Exactly so.
If you dog.
The funniest thing about that, you know. All we see are just one side communication where the dog and man is concerned. Because what command the dog go give you?
Shh. In one certain country, dog legal. Shh.
Oh yes, I saw that article.
Shh.
I saw it too. Crazy. You see? Sick. You know, the Bible says that these things are gonna happen, you know. They're gonna leave the natural
what
affection.
Tanya Stephen said it's a pity.
What's a pity, Tanya Stephen?
Tanya.
Or what? Oh, you want to play It's a Pity? Oh, okay. All right.
What is song? It's a pity, Peter McKenzie. Have a wife.
Over there in Queens. Is this my Peter McKenzie from Portland? Text me back and let me know if it's you. All right.
Is that you?
I'm a past student by the name of Peter McKenzie. I know he's abroad. But I'm not sure if he's a person who's listening now.
No.
One of my best food and nutrition male student.
No. That's not him. So, while we're on that, we have a topic here for the night. And may one of you ladies read the topic, please, so we can get into the discussion, the fruit and the meat and all sorts of stuff of the matter.
All right, so it says, dear real talk, my husband does all the chores and I'm the breadwinner. He seems comfortable with the idea of not being the provider. I give him money for grocery, clothes, and bills. I'm not ready for kids with him because of the stigma. All my friends want me to leave him. Should I divorce him? Should you? What would you do?
Okay, you can't ask me that I'm not talking about.
I didn't ask you.
Nobody look at me.
I'm talking to my listeners, my female listeners. What would you do?
That is not godlike.
What would you do, my female listeners? So you need to be texting us right now. The number is 453.
In other words,
1444. Or give us a call. We want to know what your thoughts are on this.
I'm going to paraphrase it because I'm not prim and proper. I'm not give me some clear stand. You have your man.
Mm-hmm.
Your man there yard and him a wash, cook, clean, do all them stuff.
That's a good man.
Right. And the woman at the breadwinner, she go work, earn the money, bring it in and thing. However, the man seemed to be comfortable with this because she has spent upon him, she has give him the money for the grocery, she pay all the bills, she buy him clothes, make him look at and them thing there. But at the same time, she no want to breed for him. She no want to have no pity for him. When you read it the first time, you pray that part, say, yo, she no want to get a man and a youth. And then she said, because of the stigma of her like a bad mind friend them,
mm-hmm.
I tell her if he left him. And now she is a fool full of ask if she feel divorced the man. Yeah.
Victoria,
husband. I guess when she meets that man, then she would have known all of this about him already. And decides that she's gonna marry the man.
Not necessarily.
But what happened? Is it that he was always like that?
That's
circumstances change and he had to be staying home.
Mm-hmm.
So what really happened? You know, so we have to explore all sides in terms of discussing
because
this topic.
Because if she marry him, I must something I mean, she see what she like.
Yeah, maybe him the depend on top of things them time there.
Oh,
well, she might be one of the good women them because we talk about the woman them where the man work and send her to school, and then she might be one of them will come back. So some of them go and left the man and take up new man when they meet at school for the man money.
I would have a problem with that situation, you see. If I have to be going out to do the work, take the money in, but I have to come home and do everything in the house still. Right? Yeah, but if when I get home, I don't have to do anything at all, for me, it's no problem. Yep. Because if I'm a woman and I'm staying at home and I'm taking care of the home, that's a full-time job for me.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, it's, so it's, if the man is staying at home and he's doing everything, he's washing the clothes, he's cooking the dinner, the breakfast, and everything.
Doing everything, that's a full-time job.
Doing the ironing. Man. Doing all of those things.
That would not get you.
Then I can live with it probably for a while. I probably could live with it. So in terms of circumstances, let's say he's changing jobs, or let's say he's studying, or he's doing something.
No, man,
I probably can. What if he lost his job?
Are we married to him? Or right? He could become.
I could live with that. But if it's just a man just decide that, hey, I'm not doing nothing, I'm not going to work, I'm not gonna make any contribution to the family, then I'm gonna have a problem with that.
No, but the man's contribution is to be at home and do all of them chores there.
Is
but me not understand something.
Where have is it?
Mrs. Rose, as she said, make it sound like say, the man a helper.
What make you call that helper?
Yeah, because when she going at everything. If you make breakfast,
yes,
then I feel warm too.
We need to understand that in our current society, roles are changing, you know. Roles are changing. Gone are the days when the woman would stay home and do everything.
Yeah.
So roles are changing. So if you're in a relationship and you decide that you're gonna, you know, switch your roles, so because of maybe my educational status and, you know, my, you know, the job opportunities available to me as a woman, then maybe I would have to go out and do the work while the man would have to stay home
and take care of the family.
Right?
And there's no problem. There shouldn't be no problem with that woman getting pregnant for such a man, because it means that that man will take care of that baby and take care of it well.
No, but she have a little bad mind friend them.
So our friend, she married to our husband.
No, but the stigma, because remember, the stigma right away in my mom, my man.
No, but who allowed these people who can say much about that man? Because if me and my husband, you know, not care what me and him are going to, you know, and anybody on my friend, they can chat about him as they have a mind. And me and him still a friend. So tell me now, what stigma? The stigma that she allows, because she got, they got chat.
Splash them with the holy water. Well, look here,
you stand up in my face and I'm going to discuss my husband and talk about my hell.
No, but hold on, remember, you know, is we could talk natural, no real talk.
This is real talk
right now, right?
This is real talk
right now. The reality about it is that you do have men who, for whatever the reason, they're home for an extended period of time and the man have to go and take care of the house. Right? For whatever the reason, he don't have a job.
Right.
Be it that him lose him job, get laid off, in profession, there's the job market can't fit that profession right now. Or him just is a virgin with us one, stay home. What if him is was a chef? And him just cook and go and do the thing them. You on the other hand, the woman on the other hand, have the job, she go out. But let me ask, who you think should make the executive decision in that relationship?
The man is still the head. The where he is does not place him under. He is still the head.
For me, it should be mutual consensus. For me.
What do you mean by
that? So it's not about the man making decision or the woman making decision.
Even talking about decision.
We should come together
and
discuss and make the decisions.
Like what, sir? Cause
in terms of spending the money, because
the money you're
talking about. Exactly. Because you're talking about. You're not talking about just a mere relationship there, you know, where people are just having a relationship. You're talking about a marriage relationship right there.
Hold on.
Marriage.
You said something important a while ago. More all the women them normally depend on real talk and text and cuss me out. Oh, you said the money go again. Oh, you said the money go.
This is a mutual money. Understanding.
Yeah. Said, so if the money where you work.
Yeah.
After all.
After us. The
and the money where the man work. After all.
After us.
Okay.
Us,
okay. Wanna hear that? The money where you work. After all.
Us, both.
All right,
us.
Argument done. Ladies, after this, no call us, no text us, and come both say, boy, phone the money, and the man money, I feel. No.
That's a dirty mindset.
Yeah!
That's a dirty mindset.
Believe me, people, we start like the show. We start like the show, we never like it before.
For real, I mean, you have to.
That's
you have to take care of the family. You can't think about yourself when you're in a marriage.
It's for us.
When you're in a, what you call it? What kind of relationship you would call it now when you're not married? You're not married,
yeah.
Right? That's a different thing. Once you get married and you decide that we are now together, it makes everything totally different. It flips the coin right over, right? And you can't be saying that it's all about me. Mm. So if your partner is not working, are you going to say that, well, they're not working, so you're not getting what I am working. You need to go and find work. You have to share.
No.
If he wants clothes, you have to buy it for him.
Well, a little bit.
Everything.
That, exactly.
You see, well,
and do it for you.
Cass, me tell Cass. Me tell you, Cass. Normally, I participate in if you stay on this side. Because these ladies want to turn real talk into ideal talk. And we're not talking about the ideal. We are talking about what we know, Cass. It's enough woman, even though them man make the money and the man not make the money, the man mumble pan is either the woman that just make up her mind and say, boy, it's a woman that love mine, man. Or them are gonna mumble. After a while, them are gonna mumble because Mrs. Rose say it, you know. She can't deal with it for a while. So talk to me now, Mrs. Rose. When that while up, how we go? Let's talk real.
You're not easy.
But you have to understand
it. Dealing with it for a while, it's on the basis that something may have happened while he's not working. What if my salary is not able to take care of the family, you know, fully? I'm going to need help. So I'm not going to be able to do it alone. So I can do it for a year. I can do it for 6 months. But if it's going to be like forever, then you're gonna get frustrated.
And then
you're
what?
Gonna, especially if what you are earning is not enough to take care of the family.
You'll start to tell him.
Right?
No,
we're gonna discuss it. We're gonna talk about
talk
it.
About
we're
it.
Gonna pray about it.
Yes. You come together and say, honey, this is
exactly right. We're gonna work things out so that we can get it done.
Listen, fine.
We have a lot of texts coming in, so we probably need to pause a while to read some of them.
Read one text. I'm going to take my one. Say what I want to say yet to not cast.
Go ahead.
This one said if they are both comfortable with it, then she should not leave him, but she is not, then she can.
Oh, if she's not comfortable, she can't leave him.
Yeah. But to me, it is reason why he is not working. I can't just summon. Wicked, but can't like that.
We were trying to understand this one. So I guess she's saying that if you're both comfortable, then you can stay. If you're not comfortable, leave. Right? And I guess she's saying that she's not taking a man that's so wicked for stay and not work. I think it's a natural instinct for a man to want to take care of his family. Right? When a man just decide that he's not gonna work. I guess in Jamaican colloquial we say I'm worthless, but you know. So really, do we have a lot of situations like this in our society?
I don't think so.
Do we?
No, we don't have a lot of situations like that. But we do have.
We have situations.
Because all right, me know a brethren where him did have a good job. Actually, I forgot to call and find out if I really want to give his testimony here. That he had a good job and he got laid off. Nice job. And him and his wife, them just save and them start to even do some expansion on their house. But him lose him job in the midst of all of that. So all the savings actually was going into the house.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time losing job, they actually had nothing. So she take care of everything thus far. She's able
to do it.
But it's still a bit short. And because the man used to being the breadwinner and working, he break down in tears many times.
Yeah, because he's not used to that. And you can't say that I want a real man.
Exactly.
The ball?
Yeah, because he miss doing it. You understand? This person, look here, I have an instant like that with me and my husband. And there were times when he had to be at home. And more time when we come home at evening time, I say, baby, I can't take this, you know. You understand?
Yeah.
A real man will not want to stay in the house and do all the chores.
You don't want to stay and watch you do everything, you know, but you don't have no choice. You understand? But
they're gonna go out.
She's not comfortable with it.
They're gonna go out. It's not something. So that's what I'm saying. You can't live with it for so long. Yeah. I know, you know, because a real man, 6 months, maybe a year or so, and then they're gonna get up and find something to do. They're not gonna
a real man
in the house forever.
Show a man just want to build back and go and cook
your
food.
Look here, it's all about how a man is wired.
Look here, remember, you know, when my wife just have baby, I'm a daddy for 1 week. And for 1 whole week, me wash blocks. You know what me talk about? Me wash that something there. 1 whole week, me fi hide and hang it on line.
Why?
Me can't manage that. Me off the road. My real man can't see a yard and
but
wash
that's the
that
point. That's the point we're making.
If I even that me traumatized, I'm going to even plant some of the green gold there.
The man is not going to just sit down and just want to do that.
That's what
we
said.
That's what we're saying.
That alone.
He's not going to sit down and just want to do that.
You said something since night. Sorry, Mrs. Rose. You said something since night that traumatized me.
What's that?
You emphasize, yo, the man have to wake up and make breakfast, wash the clothes, clean the house, make dinner.
That's if I'm going to be the full-time breadwinner.
And when I start
thinking about
the like
full-time housewife.
That 1 week when my daughter born and my wife, I'm going to take care of the thing, I'm going to wash that something there, old boy.
Mm-hmm.
1 week of washing that something there.
Yeah, when we're full-time housewives, we have to wash that something there too. And we go out in the public and hang it up on the line.
But a phone
with
or
no reservation. No one a feel we want. Phone or one. We wash phone. Hang it up on the line. Right?
Yes. And then said that's something of a go in a machine. You know, me want to fling in a machine. I'm going to wash or something by adding a shutter. Then turn the elephant man say, oh, bad man not beard. When the big man around here, no how me hang out. No, Cass. Me a real man. Do road. I forget somebody for wash them the party. Me can't manage it. Can't manage it. But Tamara Rose said that she can deal with it for a while.
Yeah, for a while.
No. How long is a while?
Until him get a job. So he can't be sitting. For me, if he lost his job, he can't be sitting down
and
not doing anything. He must be doing something to show that he wants to change his situation.
But do you think it can be something that the woman could get used to? Not having to do any housework?
Of course.
So basically, let's flip the coin. Let's flip the coin.
Because man do get used to not having to do any housework.
I'm going to play the devil's advocate now.
We were born not wanting to do any housework.
And I don't know if I can use this expression on radio, but
think about the holy water.
Yes. But you're going to turn the man into that M-man. We
mama
call
man.
Him in the mama man in Jamaica. You know, how many of our Jamaican men are willing to become a mama man?
The man sits home,
he does all the housework, the woman tells him what to do, you know, everything is just,
but that
him
is,
not doing anything
not,
on him own.
So, overall, what you're saying, the woman is the head there, the woman is in control of.
Right.
Right?
But that is why I asked the question.
But you have male that do these things and the woman is not in control of.
Right, that's why I ask the question when I say
so
who would make the executive decision in the house?
Both them, the men.
Both
of us.
Why? Why can't the man?
Because normally we make it the same way. Whether me a worker, him a work, the both of us make the executive decision. It's not about just one person.
Since when that happens? That happens.
Since when woman is reinstated back into their rightful position. Now, I know everybody can talk like this.
Which is what?
You have to be born again, washed in the blood of Jesus before you are reinstated back to that place.
Which is?
Where you are not under the man anymore. But you come to stand side by side as executive.
No, sir. Hold on, people. We're up on a break.
That's how it is.
Have you ever been to West Harbor Medical?
Not yet. Where is it?
KFC Plaza.
In Port Antonio?
Yes.
Oh, yes. I've been there when I was pregnant.
Good, nice place.
I did my, ultrasound?
Ultrasound.
Yeah. It's nice. It's really nice. Comfortable seats, the ambiance, it's really nice.
Remember
the TV? I haven't been there. I mean, that was maybe about 2 years or more ago.
Remember TV?
They have a, what TV? They have a television?
The monitor that they used to put on there.
No, the TV where you can go, watch.
Oh, okay.
And the pretty nurse.
Oh, okay, yes.
The pretty nurse.
Guys. I wonder if she's listening. Big up to you, pretty nurse.
That's the same
way place where doctor
Jengly
works.
Right.
Oh yes. And it was a nice, the lady who did the, I don't know if she still works there, but she was so nice. A nice black doctor, short, dark complexion. I don't remember her name, but she was really nice. Really nice. Really nice lady.
They sponsor this program.
Oh yes. Wow. Lovely. Thank you so very much.
West Harbor Medical Center.
Yes. Having any problems, you need to go to West Harbor Medical Center.
Them there. And the same plaza, where one place. Then
next to the paint shop.
Where you buy fowl, you're going to get one ketchup.
Uh-huh.
One ketchup.
Don't mention it. We're not giving them no free promotion.
One ketchup. One ketchup with two fowl and fries. You throw it dry. You have to dip that in nice soda. Up on a break. 2 minutes past 11. Real talk.
This is Styles FM.
Maintaining a healthy lifestyle begins at West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland. Open Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. We offer specialized services such as obstetrician gynecology on Thursdays and Fridays, and orthopedics the first Saturday of each month. Get general medical services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., Mondays to Fridays, and 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturdays. For more details, please call 993-283-425 or email westharbormedicalcenter@gmail.com.
Planning a party? Club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Corbin, St. Mary's, Styles FM, the People's Nation, is now on your radio. 96.1 and 96.7 on your FM band.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. Styles FM, your northeastern radio station based in Portland, Jamaica. Tune in now.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Real talk on Styles FM is sponsored by West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland.
It's really, 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 really real talk. It's really, 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 really real talk.
Whoa. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That didn't come over the air. Only on Styles. Oh my God. Yo, people, that is a joke. If I know, so, you know. Hey, see. What I'm saying, people, what me really, I forget that. Because genuinely, all right, it's like me now. Me like clean house. Me life, me spend all of yesterday. I clean my house. Mm-hmm. Really tired afterwards. But me tell the truth, me guilty as the day name guilty. You say me go my yard or my wife. Me no do nothing. Wife love me.
You think that the woman is to do all the domestic
no,
work?
No, me just probably because I don't know. Me love cook.
Mm-hmm.
Me tell you what me not like. Me not like fold up. Me not like fold up clothes.
Love me
husband. I iron every morning. Me not want to spend it with iron for the week. Every morning me iron. So if current gone, dog name the dog when I'm a supper.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But when me there, I'm Antigua Bay, me no want nothing. Me just want lounge out.
Mm-mm.
Me do the yard work, you know. Me do yard work.
Mm-hmm.
Clean up the yard. Plant one sitting over there, so. Spray the sitting them from that from insect from near me down. And me do them, when me say man work. But in the house, we sweep the veranda. But me no want nothing else. No, me spread
well,
the bed.
Well, that is it, you know. Nobody forces the male to be active in the home. It's something that him do freely. And if him do it freely and take care of everything, the woman can respect him. You know, lord over him with what he must do and what he not do. No, that's not what we are saying.
Yeah.
That's not what we are saying, you know.
Should be a help meet.
Yes.
Or?
Help meet.
Partners.
Should work together.
Yeah, but that's
what me idea. Fall short, you know.
Mm.
My husband fulfill. Exactly. Where him shall fall short in a, me fulfill. Because that is why, that is how we're compatible, you know.
Fair enough.
You hear most people talk, say, when me get a man, him have to be like me. If the two of you are the same thing.
Crazy. Can't work.
If the two of you are the same thing, it won't work.
I agree. But let me ask this.
It won't work.
So, all right. This brethren, this relationship, they married. Nothing wrong with that because at the right way, married before kids.
Mm-hmm.
Well, married whatever before marriage them say. Let's assume that that's the situation. They actually didn't fornicate. Now, she's saying, she don't say, boy, they don't. Them not get no kids yet, you know. Say she not have any, or...
She nah give him no kids. That's what it says.
Because of her friend.
Because of what?
And what her friends are saying.
She said, I'm not ready for kids with him.
Right.
Because of the stigma all my friends want. Well, she said, because of the stigma, all my friends want me to leave him. Right? And she asked if she divorce him. No, me and say people. And friends are definitely influential. Maybe, just maybe, she has said, and you can't blame her to wait out. If she go get pregnant with this virgin, yeah, and then she be in the breadwinner for whatever, God forbid, something happens to her, that child, possibly, at the time being, have it hard growing, or they are going to have it hard to care for this child. So, Moda said then, if that's the case, me understand. But she has meds. But if it is a case now where she has said, yo, she not see where this aboriginal now, want for nothing, see him start get comfortable there, and him look like him lazy and look, him just want to wash and...
The man is lazy because the man at work.
Exactly, the man is doing the household work. The man is doing the household
work. The man
work.
At work.
Right, so him is a full-time mama man.
No.
That's not what we are saying.
He's assisting in the home.
No, but you know how to assist for me. No, man. But
yeah,
you know how to not.
Yeah, read a text.
But you know how to not.
From a listener after yeah. This woman. The person said, woman, once a man show that him love you, you don't leave. Because your friend has said you must. You have a brain. Use it.
That me know.
Your friend might be jealous of you.
Mm-hmm.
That man is a good man. And him a wash a and clean. But you don't have no sense. Give the man 2 youth.
Yeah.
Else you never are going to know what you had till you lose it.
Same way, sir. I mean, 100% with that person, that
oh
takes
my goodness.
Agreement. Yeah. That is
give
so
the
true.
Man 2 youth, man. Because maybe that is what will help him to really realize that he needs
and
to get
maybe go work.
Him have work.
Get some work done.
You never know what can happen because just seeing what this man is doing tell us that this man is not a lazy man.
You don't start living until they start having kids.
Because
start having kids, that's when you just realize the work we're cut
you out. See what that man do? You sure you're saying a lazy, you know? Yes, you are lazy man. Not do nothing.
It's true.
Me I tell you, then sit down and feast off for you. Walk up and down and look girl on top of it.
Nothing. Nothing at all. It's true.
Wait for you to come back and cook the food game too.
Yeah.
Damn it, no, for the whole day and the whole night and them.
So me now fi ask if I want good quality man this.
Me have some damn no friends.
Them on road I play domino from night till the morning. And they do nothing at all.
Yeah, man, so this man is not need a to wise
man
up.
In this scenario at all.
Yeah, but...
So probably what she needs
no,
to
but,
do.
No, but well, remember, you know, careful. Him not lazy. But him like the idea of getting the money. Him like the idea of she paying the bills. Mm-hmm. Him like the idea of she giving him the money for go buy the grocery or she buying the grocery. It said that too, you know.
But of
him
course,
like the idea.
When you was out there working as the man... Didn't I like the idea of you supporting, coming in with the money, paying the bills? I can go to the store, buy the children clothes, buy my clothes and do all of that.
But that's natural for a woman.
Why is it not natural for a man?
Nah, man. That sound...
Says who?
That sound fishy.
Society's
ain't nothing fishy about that. That's a man and a woman.
It sound...
No.
If the man like that. Think about it. All right. When birthday come... Uno a licky licky, sir. I wanna get nothing.
Who is Uno?
Oh man. Oh man, would ever want sitting on birthday, Christmas.
You can't tell that.
And there are
I am
men
an example to that. When my husband wasn't working birthday. And I had to show all of those expenses. Mm-hmm. When I come home, I could cry. That table was well prepared.
Yeah.
Look here, it's set up officially.
The birthday.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
You have many ways to enhance your relationship. And trust me.
Talk here.
You mean to say the man have to out there work.
Licky, licky, woman them. Mm. Listen, when you hear that, I set up talk and make a while ago. Because you see, all out we contact. Cass, you remember the topic? They want this, they want that. Birthday.
We have
Christmas. Where the other sitting name? Anniversary or the first time them did there when their members say that's the anniversary before you're married when you're there. You know say shouldn't talk so loud. We shouldn't talk so loud. Cause so, oh my god, I want to force it now that no we shouldn't talk.
Birthday, anniversary
when
Mother's Day and Valentine's Day.
No, I'm not talking about birthday.
Mm-hmm.
Christmas. Anniversary if you're married. And if number 4 now, because that one is the one before you're married, the day when you say on the day. A first day there.
Mm-hmm.
So that's
our anniversary.
A forgive woman, forget then.
That's our anniversary.
That's our anniversary.
And so?
Not that one. Then one they start to cut out a little bit.
Okay.
Then one day, I feel like little spiegel where you're up on the side. Like Valentine's Day.
Woman, licky, licky.
Yeah,
I said, yeah.
No licky licky, because me not demand them something. Then me need to get licky licky.
That's it.
You see,
that is it, you know. You see, when you're the real man in the house, I take care and I do all of them something. Then when there's something they come and in again, give you not even feel no way. You're not even feel no way. You want
no,
care. Me, I tell you.
The woman never caught, well, this is the real talk. You don't know how old them.
Because they don't find themselves yet. And that is it, you know. That is it. Then still lost. Still a search. Anytime you find yourself on circle, you are satisfied where you're at.
Look here. You know the pressure when I come and this way then text people. Eh?
Mm-hmm. You have to teach them sense.
Because I know next week a different thing.
You want to hear this one?
After next week, some people are going to wise up.
The friends them jealous. You hear what this person is saying? The friends them jealous. Them want a man to come cook and clean.
Yeah, them.
Yeah. come cook and clean for them so they can play fool and not catch wise.
Yeah.
Mercy.
Where in the Bible?
I'm not sure. Where in the Bible said that? Well, I'm not sure what you're asking about, listener.
Brimstone.
So you need to tell us what you're asking about, all right? Hello, laugh out loud. If you love her, you're not going to look on what you're washing from what you're not. Washing. A real man, anything to make their wife happy.
Is not a man text that. Is not a man text that. Is one, one. At Daddy Road.
What is
look
the problem
here.
With that?
Oh,
what
Ms.
is
Valerie?
The problem with that?
Oh, I forgot. Should I be myself tonight, Miss Valerie? Lord God. Miss Valerie. One of our listeners, yes. She was here and she said, you when I listen to Real Talk, but that's why I squeeze your neck.
Another listener says, not my kind of relationship. If my mate having a bad time, I will be there for him, but not a forever situation. I love a strong man, a real king.
Yeah,
you know, king. Talking about king, and I started thinking about the lion. You know, that lion don't do anything.
That
he
talk
doesn't
about
do anything, you know.
None.
The lioness has to go out and do everything, find the food and everything, and take back for the lion.
But that is their domain. That's how they rule their domain.
Yeah, what man a lion?
You're not lying, you're a man.
But I like if you come in from the call.
Which one? The same one? Not my kind of relationship.
She says she wants a real man. What defines a real man?
Mm-hmm. A man on real talk.
What defines a real man? And that is the problem that we as Jamaican have most time. Because if one man not ball off of them, you think a joke?
No.
No, sir.
No.
If a man not ball off of them and talk to them rough,
no, sir.
You know, regard really? Him as real man. Me, I tell you.
I'm not all human.
And him have his strong. Strong how?
No.
I don't want no man shouting after me and, you know, treating me like I'm a child.
And then if you do right, something, a woman work that. We're not supposed to do this.
Yo. No,
what,
man.
What do you really? Because me see that man, when we are talking about another thing, it's only a real man who that do that.
Look here.
Real man do that.
Yes, you know, see your thing set up by us. See your thing by us? True, the man have a body and he rough them up. Him man a real man. But true, the man can cook and go and like some little girly thing.
The man not going like no girl. Because if he come to the test and if he put on his foot, he can put it down same way.
You don't want to put on his foot.
You know, no, sir. You
wait, me say, that's why I ask the question of the cast. Who made the executive decision? No, they want to share.
But we always did a share.
No,
we always did
share.
A share. That is it.
Then he foot not put on then.
What do you mean? Just because he's not sharing, that not mean he foot not put on?
Yeah.
His foot is down and he's a strong man because he can't allow his wife to make decision.
No.
Yeah?
Right now, lose him and lose.
No, lose him tonight.
All dirt and the foot washer. Enough, no grung to son of a fan.
Most time.
No grung enough for son of
a fan. Most time when a man is inferior of his position, you know.
Mm.
When use is control. Control. That is why most of our Jamaican men are so controlling. Because them use this now and say, this I go show off my masculineness. This I go show off who me really is as a man. And he don't really have nothing to do with anything. In fact, he's behaving like that because he feel like, say.
Good night, Carla. Good night.
Hi, good night. I just sent a text. I'm a little bit offended. About wanting a real man, a king, and this person that I wouldn't know what a real man is. I am a woman that is treated real special by my man, who loves myself and would not accept a man screaming at me, treating me in any way that I don't feel like agreeing. I do not expect that a man is going to be disrespectful to me, scream at me whatsoever. That is not my reality. And I am offended that your co-host would feel the need to say that if a man not screaming at a woman because they're a real man. You know what is my definition of a real man? A definition of a real man is a man who loves his woman and treats his woman as a queen in the same breath, holding his rightful place. I am a strong person, cannot be with a weak man. Otherwise, I'm going to govern him.
Sure.
And if you can't be a fool and work with me, you have to be strong, because I'm a very strong person. Go for what I want, get what I want. Therefore, the person standing beside me has to be a go-getter who won't get in things. That's what I call a real man.
But let me ask a question.
Who's a job? There's other things to do.
Let me ask a question. In the situation to our question, or the person that wrote us, do you think you could handle something like that? The man just, the woman do all the chores and you care for him? And actually, this gentleman, he's comfortable with it. He's comfortable. He's quite fine with it.
Not on a long-term basis. If there is a situation and he's out of a job for a period of time, I love him and I want his back. But not on a long-term basis, because that's not the kind of man I need in my world. I need somebody that is a strong pusher like myself.
Okay.
To work with me.
Where are you calling from?
You know, so on a short-term basis, yeah. Oh, right now I'm in Jamaica.
Okay, okay. Keep it locked. Thanks for the contribution.
You know? You're welcome. Bye.
All right.
Often,
right? You know, I really appreciate that you have called.
Mm-hmm.
What I think, what Sister Victoria is trying to say, that in certain areas of our society,
there are
some women who perceive a real man to be the one who is aggressive,
yes,
one who is even violent,
mm-hmm,
towards her. Right? So I know that, you know, or caller, you have a real man in your life, and you know, I want to send a shout out to that real man and let him know that we here at Styles FM sent a shout out for him.
Right.
But you know what, it remind me the other day, well, about 3 weeks ago, Cass, when we had a caller that were talking about things that happening in the what you call it now, the ghetto. And just like what you say,
mm-hmm,
them thing that the woman them like, you know,
mm-hmm,
they rough up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, no matter what, the man said, him could have X amount of girl, he just was a boy, them dead with the general, mm-hmm, and the general them, mm-hmm, have. General could have tell him if he could do anything. All when the general said, boy, I when they box him over, they feel good about that.
Because then say
you love because, same the general saying over that.
Yeah, we have to be real.
Same the general say,
mm-hmm,
boy, right now, I just saw the thing set.
Mm-hmm.
But that is one part of society. Not all persons are like that. Some that, and then again, that is how they are cultured and socialized,
right,
in that side of the island and even other places in the world.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, still, it's at a double standard, because while maybe is cultured again. While a man would want to have a woman that is independent, it is still okay if she never work, you know, and have a job for herself. Her job would be a housewife. Now, in this case, he's a house husband, right? And if the two of them have that as an understanding,
mm-hmm,
you know, suppose them have a youth and say, all right, you and our party, you're going to make sure that the homework them do and the youth them well protected. Pick them up from school, carry them go to school, pick them up from school, make sure them do them homework, talk to the teacher them, whatever report card that are your work as the man, because you like for their yard then. And my responsibility in this relationship now, as a woman now in a for them case, is to make sure that the money are run.
Mm-hmm.
So, right now where I say, all of the money where they are yard, and I take care of the thing, on the demand on a Christmas, demand on a birthday.
Really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Demand the Valentine's Day,
mm-hmm,
because Una around the house.
Yeah.
Right? She around, make over say she around the road, but that's all right. That's all right.
She's working hard for the money.
Yes.
She's working hard for the money.
Well, just to say to that caller, I meant no way to offend you, sweetheart, but what I drive at was to bring out a point, right? And I'm so glad that you could call in and explain, because so much of our young people, especially in the ghetto, their culture this way, as Daddy Rude said. They think that a strong man is somebody who's aggressive.
Yep.
Right? And so it is good that you could call in and share your view. It's never about offending one. So this is the way we like to take it at times, so that people can share and express themselves.
No, Mrs. Rose.
Yes.
What if a time comes that you are at home and Mr. Rose have to take care of you?
You mean if I am at home?
Yeah.
And he has to take care of me?
Yeah.
That's no problem.
For how long?
Forever.
Forever.
I could stay at home forever.
Forever.
Because I'm going to be doing everything. Once I'm at home, I'm going to be doing everything. I'll be the perfect wife. I know that working, I can't be the perfect wife because I'm consumed with work, you know? But I'll be the perfect wife. I'll give him everything that he wants. Everything that he needs. No, I can't prepare. I can't do all the bakings. And my husband loves big stuff. So I can't get to do all the big stuff. Like, he wanted me to bake him a tote over the weekend, and I didn't even get the time to bake him the tote.
How could you?
I felt so bad. You know? So, but, you
nah,
know,
man,
yeah,
the man want tote.
I'll, you know?
Hold on.
I'll do everything.
The man want tote.
I should have mentioned that, you know. I should, because he's probably listening. I'm sorry, baby. You know,
the man,
I'm going to let you get it some more, right?
Madan. You know that, girl. You have to go get a toto.
All right.
Anywhere.
No.
In toto
no,
there.
No, no.
You can't get a toto anywhere.
Anyway, the toto there.
No.
You feel for your toto, right?
No, absolutely not.
You spend
the
time
tomorrow.
And you sacrifice half of everything. Everything that you are. And you can't get a little toto.
Hear me now, Mr. Rose.
It's a rouse.
You're listening. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
But then, they fight for me. They fight for me. Can't believe
them fight for me. So, you know, all of those things. So, I'll be a good housewife. I'll do everything. I wake up in the morning. I make a breakfast. Set the table. I'll do everything. I'll be a good wife. Right. As a matter of fact, I'm praying that one day I'll stop working and stay right at home, take care of the kids. Mm. You know, I'll sew the curtains, the bedspread, and I'll do all of those things.
Where you get that from?
So, I don't know if I want to.
I'll do all of that.
I'll make cushions. Earlier on,
I'll do all of those things.
You're young, so yeah. I guess you
look
want
here,
to
move.
I've moved from there.
Yes.
You understand?
But then
and I've grown over the years.
When I'll,
and I like what I do.
But then few time when I'll mail done, I'll clean up all the yard and I'll be and I'll carry and come someone give me like $5,000 and me and I say, yo, go on.
Eh? Really?
Yeah.
For what?
Do what?
Encouragement, sweet labor.
Yeah, man. Make me feel all good, right. Man. Give me like five pack in a man and I feel good.
You're gonna get it. You gonna get it, man.
I hope so.
You like that?
One day,
yeah.
Karen, you hear that?
Exactly.
Yeah,
he's gonna get it.
Yeah, more and it feel like Cassidy. No woman never spend for me like them way there. Never. All these years, never spend for me.
You sure? What you're getting
maybe
is
not
is,
techie.
It's like, you know.
Get what?
Can you, I mean, it's priceless. Whatever you're getting from a relationship is priceless. You know, it's priceless. You can't pay for it. When you spend all your earnings.
My insurance
money,
due December.
May I
give a message? My insurance due December for my car. December it due. Right?
Yeah.
The 22nd of December. Message me again.
Who you sending that message
right.
to?
Just a talk, me talk. Me just a talk, me talk. Right?
I really want somebody to surprise this young man, you know, because... He needs to feel that way.
Yeah.
It's a fantasy.
Mm-mm. No. No.
Yes.
What happened? Living the fantasy world. Oh, I think the person was answering that when I asked about the relationship, common law. But it's not common law. I'm talking about a relation, like courting, you know?
Common law relationship.
Yes.
What is common law relationship to that person?
I was comparing to say that when you're in this relationship.
Living in a committed right. lifestyle.
Like, yeah, and, yeah, and then I'm married. Yeah, yeah,
it's
yeah,
common
yeah.
law.
Common law, yeah.
I wasn't even thinking about common law. It was more like dating and courting. Courting, you know? So, for me, you shouldn't be living with a person if you're not married to them. That's
why would
crazy.
You want to commit to somebody who didn't do
all right, but let me ask a question. All right, let me ask a question.
What is question?
Victoria, you're really good at this one. You know what's going on your crush. He said, why would you really want to live with somebody and this one no one married to you?
That's crazy. Why would you, why would you buy the milk if you have the cow?
Why would you buy the milk if you have a cow? That's only a little bit.
What?
Why would you buy the milk?
Why would you buy the milk when you can't get the
cow? Exactly.
But then suppose suppose an a dairy cow.
What?
A livestock.
Mm-hmm. That's a different business.
No, sir.
Not just for me.
We're up on a break, people. When we get back, we're in the last half an hour. It's now 11:30. Real talk.
Maintaining a healthy lifestyle begins at West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland. Open Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. We offer specialized services such as obstetrician gynecology on Thursdays and Fridays, and orthopedics the first Saturday of each month. Get general medical services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m., Mondays to Fridays, and 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturdays. For more details, please call 993-2834-5 or email westharbormedicalcenter@gmail.com.
BJ Patterson, Edward Siaga, Bruce Golden, Portia Simpson Miller, all took their seats on Hard Topic. Since 1995, the hardest topic has been discussed on Satcom Cable Entertainment Plus. Now, Styles FM takes it to the wider population. Hard Topic is on Styles FM this and every Tuesday night, live from 8:30 p.m. to 10 p.m. We discuss politics, sex, religion, current events, you name it, and you have a chance to participate. Join your host, Colin Anthony, a.k.a. Shaq of Fame, and DP, live 8:30 to 10 p.m. Styles FM and Entertainment Plus.
When it comes to filling a prescription, there's only one place that comes to mind. Supercare Pharmacy, 1 Bridge Street, Port Antonio. They offer 12% discounts on all prescriptions, have a truly friendly and caring staff. Not to mention, they have a wide range in household gifts and cosmetic care. And they're open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 7 p.m., Saturdays, 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. And they offer the best prices in Port Antonio. And for your convenience, they're open Sundays, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. or call us at 715-5141. Supercare Pharmacy. The pharmacy that truly cares.
Real talk. Real talk. Real talk. Real talk.
Real talk on Styles FM is sponsored by West Harbor Medical Center, shop number 322 West Street, Port Antonio, Portland.
It's really, 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 really real talk. It's really, 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 really real talk.
No, people. Off air, we have a little discussion. I mean, unlike when me and Cleo talk off air, we can't tell what we're going to discuss on air. I think we have some purged people here. And I'm saying, but I agree with the level of purging still, you know. I feel like some Cersei business are going. But, I mean, what you really say a while ago? If you can't, if you get the milk.
Why bother buy the cow?
Why bother buy the cow? Yeah, really, because.
No, you got to discuss and then I read it, because there's right? something in it about you.
Oh, about me, okay. I'm saying, no, they pressure me every week, right? I'm saying, why bother married? if you're there with this man, if you're 10, 15, why bother married? We know that is not the topic, people, but seriously, we're not talking about that half ear.
Mm-hmm.
Why bother? That change up everything, you know?
It makes your relationship real.
Real
relationship real.
Make your relationship legitimate.
Exactly.
I understand.
Legitimate.
Yeah, but if it, if legitimizing the relationship no means say, you never have a relationship before.
Well, you think it's so good.
You don't
good.
Start living until you're married.
You think it's
what?
So? Let me
start
show him
living
something.
Until you're married.
Right now, enough man are dead through they're married.
Yes, really? Because they don't understand what marriage is all
exactly.
about. But you think you look good after one man and one woman for 25 years and one of them dead when you go off in a rally a year, but dear friend.
Dear friend. Imagine that.
Eh?
25 years.
No,
to
man.
Be
how much children
friend.
You not have together?
Dear
and
friend.
Dear friend.
This isn't the right good. This isn't the right good. This isn't the right good.
So you got your dear friend.
Dear friend.
Then there's nothing wrong
you
with that either.
You
don't anything legitimate.
You don't have
yeah,
the status.
All long. And we love each other. We not left go nowhere.
You can't get some material now because, you know. Some people have
where we are weird pan.
Nah, man.
You know weird pan.
You
know, either you love me,
you're
your
married.
Wife, or you're not going to marry me because you just want me for your mistress.
Exactly.
No, but nothing wrong with that either.
What you mean? Say nothing wrong with it.
Legally,
put on close pan that argument.
No,
right
legally
now.
You're entitled to everything with the wife. With the wife
tell,
the get, except the dear friend part.
Mm-mm.
Because
really?
You get the same half.
Look here, you see, we say we're a common law relationship is right now. It is. You can't go into the courtroom and you can't get something when the man did. But we see people come in and the respect not dead ekawa. You're not legally married. And if you have some outside pitney and sitting dead left, they fight you and push you out. Look here. You have his strong.
Worse if he was married before you.
Yeah.
Man,
I'm you.
Wife resurrect at death.
No. Let me tell you now tonight, Oman.
No,
relationship
no,
is resurrected at death.
We can't.
You
absorb.
Live with this man.
I knew somebody.
Clean him, take care of him.
They were separated like for years. I came to Portland and they were separated. I've been in Portland like, for now 11 years. And
no,
those people were separated like for years before I came to Portland. Right, and when that person died, you know who was in charge?
The wife.
All right.
Yeah.
So the sweetheart couldn't come and say
she got
nothing.
No.
The wife
she got
was in charge.
Was the
all right.
The cleaning of the mess.
All right. Me glad you said that. You see, if the man and the wife, if they never married, him could have easily just say your baby will left. Argument done.
I saw you want to do it,
really?
And I saw you figure.
I don't matter the man more time.
So if
you more time, your wife
you
right now
say,
left, you know.
Let me show you something. Because
and then you got bill back. You see that bill back part there?
Yes,
when your husband left, on a bill back, that funded dead out of when you're married.
Bill back.
That's not true.
Bill back.
That's not true.
Yeah, man, that's true,
I
man.
I totally disagree with
when
you.
When your husband left. You can't say you're crying right
true.
Now. We can't say you're crying right now. We left.
Mm.
We can't do that.
Right. You're not supposed to do that anyway, because I give my body, my all to you, and just one day just I'll get up and talk about we left.
No, man, no, man, the body part there, I find long the cause. Uno get body and we go to body and everybody give body. That part no count. No at all.
That's well wrong.
No,
that is where you guys are so wrong.
We go to full body too.
Look here, woman, don't give away your body outside a commitment.
Thank you.
Then we
because
committed.
When children come outside a commitment is not
no
a nice thing.
No man is going to buy the
committed.
Car when you can get the milk for
no
free.
No commitment in what you're saying.
Of course, because we run a risk.
When you can get the milk for free.
We run a risk and going away.
Look here, you see how many times you see some man just pick up some woman and turn them in a baby madam bite and you look, then left them and say they're not good enough and got married to somebody else.
Thank you.
No, man.
May I tell you, it happened. That is how we see our society set up.
Yeah, but
female, value your body.
He's not going to be fooling around with a woman
a
that he wants to be his wife.
Right, he's not going to do that.
He's not.
Look here.
A trap.
The lady would just come off the phone and say a man, a strong man, sees his woman has her queen.
Yeah.
No, you're not going to just get up tomorrow, man, and just denounce your queen.
Exactly.
No, then a princess exactly. And princesses,
here,
man.
We women in society cause men to do what they do to us. Because it's time
know,
the woman
boy,
stands
up. A trap here, man. Nobody listen to certain things.
Women,
in that trap.
You need to stand. The moment you start to stand up, society will change
as a
where the men
fact,
are concerned.
When it's so rich, 5 years, like 4 years, 4 and a half years, you're caught. Because after 5 years, you know, say, you get you're on lockdown legally.
What?
You don't know that?
Yeah, what am I saying?
5 years after, if you and a woman live together, dead together for 5 years. A 3 year custody? Would I get catch?
3 years. Once you're together for 3 years.
Who would I get catch? A 5 years. A 3? It change?
You know, see,
so nah, man, that makes sense, because think about it. You're there, you tech. You just start your tech and you're not there. But if you done road boy, you salt. No, it can't work. 5 years. 5 years, it can't work. Well, I'm Swiss of Victoria.
Yeah, they are you take on what?
No, man, can't say this at 3 years.
Your relationship, once solid. You're with her for 5 years, it's then you know solid. Say it's solid.
No, that means legally, you're entitled. Your entitlement is just as that. As
a wife?
As a wife, right.
Oh, really?
So, but can't say no, 3 years.
There must be something that's not. 3 years? Same as a wife?
No, sir.
That can't
no,
be
no, sir. No, sir. No, man.
No, can no, be man. In a Jamaica.
In a 3 year, no, so sir. What? After 3 years, she feels that she a wife. Was no, sir.
No.
Can't work. 5 years can't work, ish.
You know, worst thing to hear women talking, oh, I'm the wife. And, you know, wife where?
Wife. Nobody wife. Wife. My first choice.
You know, I'm thinking just listening to you guys.
You made to hear too.
Bubbling about as if, wife not no feelings, woman not have no feelings.
Yeah. When I say she not have no feelings.
Why is it a woman enter a relationship with a man? What is that woman looking for?
Money.
Oh, that's what you really think. Money. That's not every woman case.
You know, what else?
To give her money to do what? You're not up for sale. You're not putting yourself up for sale. So why money. Are you going to enter a relationship?
Just and even money? even these women who enter a relationship for money, there is somebody that they want to marry to them. There is not for money.
They're still waiting for that nice and shiny armor.
They're still looking for that shiny armor.
That's why the woman them said them about three different men. One with the money. Oh, you got Cassie. Never remember, Natasha would have to tell.
That is it.
It quite
so
clear,
if you have to go look for one man with Dash. Money, one with honey, one with what?
Money.
Look here. And if you look carefully, all three qualities can be in one man.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then again, you have to realize too, in a relationship, you're not gonna find all the qualities in a man. I remember I read an article one time where it said that you may find like 82% or, you know, 90% in the man that you have.
Yeah, yes.
And most times what people do is go out and try to find the 10% when they have all of 90 right there with
that
them.
That is so true. That you is know? So true. And they run and left the 90, I'm going to get 120%.
Right, exactly, or 10%.
No, you said that 20%. You said on the deal with the thing right now. Just like with exam, the first question value 30%, right? And then the rest of question them break up as on 10-10 mark and some 5-5 mark. It might add up to 70%, but at 30% there, very, 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 very important. It's almost like you still fail the exam.
Mm-hmm.
So at that 20%, at that 30%, then maybe the smarty lock. Then at that, the man go look for man.
And he not go find out the road.
No, man, at 30 days, at 30 days,
make
everything sort out.
Where they?
You know, the other woman.
Who tell us so?
No, that the man go look for.
She's lacking it's in not all there. 70%.
No, man.
So you go put the when two women together, forget the 100.
100.
And I'm telling you, it's not there.
How come?
Because look here, you go always want.
No, they wanna have it.
May I tell you? You're going to always want.
Want what at?
Anything you feel say they could have found in a one other.
Alright, watch me now. You see that 30% there, a performance. That 30% of performance, she could have washed, cooked, clean, and do every single thing, work and mind and everything, and can perform. Have to go on.
And you will still find your man go out there and find one woman who can perform and do everything and he's still gonna worry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, but I perform there.
You know why that is? Because Salaman. A man without God can never be satisfied.
Salaman never have God.
Look here, Solomon of God. But Solomon never possessed the Holy Spirit at all points in his life.
Just like David.
And so he was searching. If you read Solomon's book, intelligence search out folly, in search out mistake, in search out everything. And when he add it all up, it was all vanity. And so man need to know this. Man need to know this. The only time you are truly fulfilled, because that part of you must be fulfilled by God himself. So no, search all over where you want to search. At the end of your days, you're going to feel as if there is something else that you need to do.
So you feel say Solomon would have one woman, he would have feel better.
If Solomon had the Holy Spirit.
Plus a woman.
He need have many women. He need have many women.
So he could have all of them plus baptized.
Plus what?
Me can't explain to you this, you know. Because you're not coming. I want, even though I'm on this show, and you say it's real talk or reality, I need to show man what they need. Because that's what I'm here for. Mm-hmm. I need to show man, look, say, look here, you're outside of God and you're thirsty.
Yeah.
You have so much thirst and you're looking in various places to quench these thirst, to meet these needs.
Yeah.
Solomon have everything that his heart could desire. Everything he's saying, setting eye upon, you know, making eye starve in full them. But yet still, there was need.
And you know the need, right?
Solomon had how many wives?
300 wives and 700 how much concubines.
And the man was still miserable, searching. You tell me, he had money. There was no man living today had money like Solomon back then. Why wasn't he satisfied with his life? Why?
Never baptized.
It's not that he wasn't baptized. There was a yearning, and there is a yearning in every human being. Every human being. And until you come to know your maker, this place will never be full.
But that means it never have nothing to do with the woman. So then.
Even when you are out of a relationship.
Even when you're out of a relationship, you can't be satisfied. You will still be
feeling satisfied.
You can't be made whole.
That's true.
You can't be so easy. You don't have to chase nothing and run back or nothing. You are old. So when you come into a relationship, you don't come missing.
So, let me ask you,
so when the two old meet, that man that is old, because look here, a woman will want and still a search, not ready for a marriage relationship neither, I know. A man that wants and still searching, it must, a man and a woman must learn to live with themselves first.
Live alone.
Live alone. If you can't live with yourself, you can't live with nobody.
I mean, it's easy to live with. It's easy to live with.
And this is what we see in our society, in our world. People feel and they always a search and a gravitate after me must have a woman, me must have a man, me must have this, me must have that. And that's the urge and the weight of sin because they are thirsty.
No, man.
Going after things that cannot satisfy them.
No, but that's a bio. That has nothing to do with
that's bio. That's the woman. That's your life. Religion, I'm not talking about a religion. I'm talking about experience.
Yeah, but may I say?
Religion, I'm not talking about religion. I'm telling you that the day you come to know God for yourself, I'm not talking about no religion. I'm talking about a one-to-one relationship with the Almighty God. And when you start to know him and hear him voice, you will never thirst.
No, man.
No, you won't fit thirst. That's it. You want to thirst. And that's what becomes your God.
You'll
never thirst. Never thirst. Because he's now your comforter. He fills you up. No, he satisfies.
So where the buyer part come in?
So look here, let me tell people this, married people. If you think that principle alone can govern your marriage and make it all right without Jesus, you are in for a failure.
It's true.
You are in for a failure. Because when you come contact with Jesus and fall in love with him, he's going to enhance your relationship. He's going to make it better. He's going to make it the relationship that it's supposed to be.
He makes
That's why we search.
Let's not let Jesus have everybody heart weak.
Heart no weak in this man thirsty, and that's why they go and commit this three, some two, some one. So, all of the foolishness because they are looking for something to satisfy the urge of sin.
And they're still not feeling satisfied.
And they're still not full them.
After doing all
that, they're still miserable.
Still not satisfied.
I can admit an evil and judgment day. I've never been in none of them someday. Never been in none of them someday, people.
Don't be in those things, sweetheart. Let the person who's supposed to fulfill you.
Exactly.
Because your wife cannot do it. Your children cannot do it. No money you have in the bank cannot do it. No amount of lifestyle that you live and explore in will ever fulfill you. Man fallen from God, and that's what the connection was supposed to be. That's how man was created to live, connected with God. And so you can search as you like and do what you
want. Are you saying to me that a man can just be single and just have God in their life and good?
Sure. Yes, a man can be comfortable. A man can be comfortable. Yes.
Just can't.
And in good.
Yeah,
Jesus is able. That is why we call him the greater one. You hear them say sin, temptation out there, bad and temptation out there, high. And when you get saved, you're going to manage the temptation. Them. If you know God, he is more powerful than any urge of sex or anything that you have where you think you can control. He is the greater one.
Well, God.
See, maybe you need to say a prayer.
No, may I wait till my time. No rush. I'm waiting till my time.
We're gonna read in
the, yes, read the text and.
Somebody says, I think it's fair enough for the woman to give the man a child. After all, he shows that he is not willing to do something. On the other hand, the girlfriends only want her to leave the man so they can have him. And friends like these people.
You don't want.
And the gentleman that's talking with you ladies over the radio.
Oh my.
I think you're a pessimist.
Wow.
At some point, you're talking negative things.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my. Oh God.
I
say man and woman are not equal. Oh, he's saying, where in the Bible you find a text to say that man and woman are equal?
Are equal.
Mm-hmm. Where in the Bible you find that text?
Where in the Bible?
That's what he wants to know.
If he goes to Genesis, when God creates Adam, you know, he said, what are you, have dominion? It's not just the man, you know. It's after sin took place that he said to the woman, now you shall be longing after your husband.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? That was the curse.
Gosh, she have to try and make up for what she caused him for doing.
That was the curse. But when you are reinstated and you have come out from under that curse, Tamara, you're no longer under. You're not longing for, because you are made whole. You are made satisfied.
Okay.
Because you can only stretch out for something you have, you know. The desires are going to burn for things that you are still thirsty for. But when you come in contact with this new life, the born again process and all of that, you see, people can express it to people when I understand, you know.
So in essence, listener, we are using the point in the Bible that says God took the rib, the rib from his side to indicate that the man and the woman is, they would be equal. Mm-hmm. So he didn't take a bone from his head to indicate that the man would be over the woman.
Right.
Neither did he take from his legs or so to indicate that he should trample the woman under his feet. So the fact that he took the bone from his side
this
is an indication that they are.
This person might be referring to Peter, someplace there in the New Testament where they said the man is the leader. The leader don't mean that they're not equal, you know. Just because we don't have the same function, that don't make us not being equal.
I want him.
You understand?
Lead.
Exactly.
No, sir, I want him.
Are we getting a call? We're getting a call.
Okay.
Sit on. Oh, what happened?
Go ahead, caller.
The call got disconnected, Mr. Brown. Would you be kind enough to give us back a call? So we're expecting this call before the time is out, all right? So please call us back. So yes, definitely. So we need to go back to the topic because we're almost... You know, at the end, you know,
you know, should, are we saying that the, it's okay for the man to stay home and work, or is it that he needs to get up and go out and find something to do?
We want our man to be strong and we want them to be working. But if it's a case where this man is down for a moment, down for a season, then we, the woman, if we are in a position to make things happen in the home, then we can do it with joy and still have respect for them.
Exactly.
And still see them as our co-partner.
Because
that's what we are.
Yes.
Wow.
Definitely.
People, it's been a good night, a powerful night, a different experience.
I need to hear from Mr. Brown. So, Mr. Brown, if
Real
you're listening,
talk.
Please call back.
You know, it's been a long night, a very, very good, informative night.
Mm-hmm.
Two strong-willed, strong voice, you know, women, independent,
right.
Women, hard-working women. Mrs. Miller can relate to
yes.
some aspect of the situation here, and her husband obviously has done what he should do as the man, the real man, right? And Mrs. Rose.
Yeah, can relate too.
Right? She can relate. That's what she just said, which was different from when she started off. Right? So, I'm going to say nothing about that part there. But, you know, it was really nice having you both here sitting
yes.
in for Lady Cleo, who is ill.
It's been a pleasure.
Right. Cleo, you need to rest, girl. You work too hard, you know. Rest. I have the same problem, too. I can tell you, late night and up every night is not healthy. Right? And all the persons, them, I want to make this announcement that there's a thing at Styles FM where we watch the statistics. And I can say Mondays had always been one of the lowest days. And for the past week or so, Monday have the top listenership.
Okay,
right?
Great.
Online, you know, and I'm sure in Jamaica here as well. So I want you all to tell a friend about Styles FM. You know, everybody just tell somebody to tell somebody about Styles FM.
Pass it
along. We can't do anything else but grow, and you have all been here from when I did two night over weekend or one night over Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
You know, then it went to Thursday and then to Wednesday and now full week. The bill them turn up still, but we really appreciate you stuck it out with us, and we can't not much better but grow.
Mm-hmm.
Cause see, Mondays grow.
Exactly.
Real talk.
Yeah, man.
And as usual, in closing, I always say, big up my wife, be life. Real talk. Yesterday?
And we have to big up my husband, so life too, Victoria.
How you mean?
Yeah. Keena Rose.
They are our covering.
Exactly.
That's what the Bible
calls it. Yep.
Are they up or then down? Don't know.
True. Real talk. Thank you, people. And until next week, Real Talk. Big up West Arbor Medical. Thanks for supporting Real Talk and Styles FM in general. And people, you must go out and check out that medical center.
Yeah.
You know, it's really nice, really comfortable, and warm people.
No, the ground floor. You don't have to climb any steps.
Right, you know, really
just
nice.
Get out. You could park your car right in front of the office and walk in.
Walk in,
yes.
Yeah, man, definitely, people. It's a really nice place, and them definitely endorse Real Talk. So we have to endorse about them thing, you know.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Good night.
Good night.